High school football is on the air. HavenFootball.net is pleased to present tonight's Strathaven football game. Today's PIAA District 1 5A championship game is between your number 2 seed Strathaven Panthers and the number 1 seed Chester Clippers.
And play fake, back to pass his kitchen. Looking. Once it all down this near sideline, has Fisher out here. Who's got it? Tiptoes inside. Give is to Kaufman off the left side. He's driving the pile into the secondary. Kaufman explodes and he'll finish in the end zone. No flags. And the Panthers...
Tonight's game is sponsored by the Swarthmoreian Weekly Newspaper, true local coverage of Swarthmore, Wallingford, and surrounding neighborhoods, published since 1893. Steve Tobbs, Allstate Insurance and Media, Auto, Home, and Life. You're in good hands with Allstate. AMF Auto Clinic, taking care of your cars since 1961, located in Brookhaven on Edgemont Avenue. Sandy McCulley at Berkshire Hathaway Home Services and Media. Give her a call when buying or selling your home. Ducklings Early Learning Center in Wallingford. Daycare for ages 6 weeks to 5 years. Scarpagnano Plumbing. Over 20 years experience for all your plumbing needs in Wallingford. Proud Haven supporters Mary and Larry Luter. Go Haven! Rose Tree Wellness Center. Complete chiropractic treatments featuring ART therapies in Media. We get to the root of the problem. Here are tonight's internet announcers, the voices of the Strathaven Panthers, Brian Carroll, Pete Fulginetti, Andrew Kaufman, and Mike Mayer.
Back in early August, 24 teams at the District 1 5A level had dreams of maybe playing Thanksgiving weekend. Through four rounds of the playoffs, when it's all said and done, teams from Bucks, Montgomery, Chester, and Delaware counties are hoping they're still strapping on the helmets. So with all that mileage in between, on the busiest travel weekend in the country, how ironic that the number one seed and the number two seed share a border. The visiting Strathaven Panthers drive about 2.5 miles down the street to take on the top-seeded Chester Clippers in today's 5A District 1 championship here on HavenFootball.net. Good evening, everybody, or, well, good afternoon. I need to shake that off for a minute. It's our first afternoon game of the season. Beautiful afternoon here for football, and we hope everybody watching and listening have having and had a wonderful Thanksgiving weekend. And we are thrilled to bring you the 5A District 1 championship today here on HavenFootball.net. I'm Brian Carroll, bringing you play-by-play, joined here by Mike Mayer and Andrew Kaufman. Pete Fulginetti's away with family. Say hello to him and Tony Jester, who have been terrific for us, helping out all season long, and wish them well and safe travels in the weeks ahead. And, of course, Mike Clancy here running the camera for us, as always. And it's a party here at Chester on Thanksgiving weekend. People are excited for the Clippers' first ever District 1 final appearance. On the flip side, Strathaven can't say it's really old hat in the sense that you have new players every year and a new opportunity for different players. But when you have a coaching staff that's been together for going on 30 years, and head coach Kevin Clancy's been here since 1991, and now in a District 1 record-setting 14th appearance in the District 1 final, Coach Clancy looking for district title number 13, 30 years since his first one back in 1993. And what an opportunity today for both the Panthers and Clippers to perhaps play next Friday night in the Final Four in the state of Pennsylvania. So Mike Mayer joining us as always. And Mike, what a fun season it's been. No lack of excitement on the Strathaven side. Most games have come down to the wire. Last week, no exception, of course, in the semifinal win over Springfield.
I was just glad we got out of there with a win. I mean, I was, after playing Springfield and coming from behind in the second week of the season, that was the last team I wanted to face again. And we, of course, ended up doing exactly that. And they gave it all. You know, Haven got off to a really quick start, and then as has happened to them during the year, the second half was like couldn't finish a drive, and you know, defense was getting a little beat up, and you know, Springfield came back and made it a 2-point game and went for it and didn't get it, and that was the end of it. Well, and they did try to kick a field goal towards the end. They did drive enough to get within 40 yards, which was about 10 yards too short for that field goal to go, and Haven comes here. They're not going to be able to do that this afternoon. They're going to have to lead this game, and they're going to have to lead it. I don't think they're going to be able to lead it by, you know, heavy-duty multiple scores, but they're going to have to play four quarters of football to get good. Chester has a habit of getting behind a little bit and then coming back and just burying you in the second half. And with Haven's history of what they do in the second half, that's not going to work here, because if we're up by 14 at the end of the first half and we can't put together any offense, that may be the end. But listen, real quick, I do have a graphic here for people to take a look at, which is how everybody got here. Strathaven beat Garnet Valley by a substantial score. Upper Dublin was pretty close, 5 points. And Springfield, of course, was a squeaker. Chester, by the way, both teams are 12-1. Chester beat Upper Moreland substantially, 44-0. And then clobbered Phoenixville, which was, I think, a surprise to everybody, 40-14. And then Westchester-Ruston gave them a battle, led early, fell behind, then kind of made a play for it at the end, but came up short, 26-20. So, you know, both teams, you know, they've lost one, they've seen adversity, they've come from behind. I think this is going to be a great game. I think it's going to come down to mistakes. I mean, if you get into the red zone, which is, you know, inside the 20, you're going to be able to finish. Are you going to get in there and fumble a ball? Are you going to have a penalty that kills your drive? And I think that the team that makes, you know, as is mostly true in football anyway, the team that makes the mistakes will not win today.
And today, again, limiting mistakes has been a challenge for both teams, frankly. Chester, again, go back to week one when they were shut out by Perkiomen Valley and really sort of built it from there. Had two close wins in weeks two and weeks three over Cheltenham and Phoenixville, respectively, and have been on a roll since, have the Clippers, and have really, with the exception of last week where Ruston kept this thing close until the last minute and a half, you know, frankly, the Clippers have handled everybody. And it's been with a balanced offense this year, much more balanced than last year's version, with a sophomore quarterback who rewrote the school record book last year as a freshman. The numbers aren't quite as eye-popping, but boy, has Jalen Harris had a terrific sophomore season, 23 touchdowns against just 4 interceptions, throwing the football for over 1,500 yards. And his favorite targets, a 6'5" tight end headed to University of Connecticut next year, Dominic Toy, who will double as a defensive end. And not too bad when your other favorite receiver is your twin brother.
Yep.
Deron Harris at split end and does a little bit of everything for this team. He handles the place-kicking duties, the punting. He's the return man. We'll call number two's name quite a bit today. But the offensive line for Chester does just enough. They've got good size, and they do just enough to crack open a few holes for a talented trio of running backs this year who've had to replace a 1,300-yard rusher, number 21, Deshaun Jackson, out of the lineup today due to PIAA transfer rules. But they've used 3 running backs in the playoffs quite well, sharing the ball between Larry McDaniel, who had over 100 yards against Ruston last week and a big score, along with Shamar Williams, Nareem Melvin, and Jarrell Palmer shuffles in there at fullback once in a while. He caught a touchdown pass against Ruston a week ago as well. So that offensive line for Chester, big and strong, does a good enough job pass blocking for a very elusive quarterback in Jalen Harris. The Panther defense will certainly be tested today. On the offensive side for Strathaven, you know it's all about the wing tee, as it's been for the last 30-plus years here under head coach Kevin Clancy. Teams always say, well, we know what's coming, but can they stop it? And, you know, with these two teams having played each other only one time, and not at all since 1995, maybe that unfamiliarity is a bit of an advantage for Strathaven if they take care of the football. Seeing the wing tee for the first time sometimes gives some teams some fits, but the Chester defense allowing only 11.4 points per game, fourth best in scoring defense in all of District 1 this year, should come in confident, fast, and furious here on their own home field as the top seed. Panthers need to, as Mike said, share the ball, take care of the ball, and may need to string it out 3, 4, 5 yards at a time. If you hit a big play or two, great. If you don't, maybe it's a drive like we saw Springfield put together last week,
right,
that chewed up 11 minutes of the first quarter and staked the Cougars to an early lead with a 19-play drive. So more than one way to skin a cat. The Panthers will try it. anything they can to slow down a Chester offense and penetrate a tough Chester defense. And over on the far sideline, you can see the Clippers in their orange uniforms head to toe making their way onto the field and greeted by a number of Chester alumni on the field here. Lots of people, a sort of homecoming here, Thanksgiving weekend for both sides. What a terrific atmosphere. Mike, we were joking, and Andrew as well, to say there's we've got, I don't know, I think there's as many smokers out here as there are school buses for the pregame tailgates. I hope there's some leftovers for us once this thing's finished. But, again, terrific atmosphere. Crowd starting to fill in, and we're looking forward to a great football game.
And it should be a great football game.
And there's a line around the corner of people still waiting to get into this place.
Good.
Really?
It's good. Yeah, it's, oh, yeah, look at this.
It's all the way down the block.
We've got a few hundred people behind us waiting to work through the gates here. So these stands will be full shortly. Over on the far sideline, the Strathaven Marching Band. Looks like they're going to be standing over there today. Not enough room in the visiting seats. And so the Panthers over to our right at the moment, looking in their white uniforms, the road whites, with the black numbers on the front and back, black pants and silver helmets, led by head coach Kevin Clancy in his, well, running out of ways to say it when you've won the seventh most games in high school football history here in Pennsylvania. 356 career wins for Coach Clancy, 289 of them here at Strathaven since 1991. The Clippers led by first-year coach Dennis Shaw, but he's been here a while. He was an assistant for 7 years before this. And Coach Shaw and the Clippers making their first ever appearance in the District 1 final. Strathaven 12-1 all-time in the District 1 final. When they get there, they usually win it. Their only loss was in the first ever District 1 final back in 1992. They went up the turnpike and lost a tight one, a one-score game to Hatboro-Horsham back in 1992. And since then, every appearance in the District 1 final, the Silver and Black have gone home happy. Thanks again to Dave Berman for some help this week. He was posting a number of things about the history between these two teams. These two teams played every year back from 1968 to 82 when this was Nether Providence High School. But once Strathaven came into effect in 1983, conferences were realigned, and they played only one time since then. In 1995, Chester came out on top in that one. That was Dan Mulhern's sophomore year, to give you an idea. Dan Mulhern, longtime Panther great, went on and played terrific football at the University of Delaware for 4 years and has now been several years as the Panthers' ninth grade coach. So we're going back to his high school days, early high school days, since these teams last met. Coach Dennis Shaw, West Catholic grad, terrific high school career himself back in 2006, sort of set the stage for a big run for them. But in the meantime, he's been at Chester his eighth year overall, first year as the head man and athletic director, LaDante Bell. We thank him for helping get things set up when we arrived here today as well. So, glad you're joining us live or on the archive. Captains are ready to meet at midfield for the Clippers. Wearing number two, your all-purpose, do-everything defensive back and wide receiver is Deron Harris. Number zero, 6'5", tight end, defensive end, Dominic Toy. Number 64 is your left tackle, Jerry Young. Number three is quarterback, Jalen Harris. On the far side, walking towards us for the Panthers, number 25 is split end and defensive back, A.J. Glavicek. Number 77, Bill Brown. Number 20 is halfback and linebacker Marco Kaufman. And your quarterback and punter, number 6, Jake Kitchen. So we have lots of excitement here, Mike. Go ahead.
It looks like Chester deferred.
Okay. All right. So, and here we go. Strathaven will receive the opening kickoff, move left to right. A little bit of a crosswind blowing towards us at the moment. But nothing like last Saturday where that Ruston and Chester game, there was a stiff wind blowing left to right for most of the game that affected the pass game for both teams, the punt game for both teams as well. And so here we are, ready to rock and roll for the District 1 title. All right, stick with us. We're going to be back for after a short timeout. Thank you again to our many sponsors. We'll be back for the tail end of the national anthem. You're listening live to high school football right here on havenfootball.net.
Welcome to Allstate, where everyone saves when they bundle their home and auto insurance. Isn't that right, Frank?
I saved 25%. Booyah.
You protected your casa?
Sure did.
And the Frank tank?
You know it.
And now you're relaxing.
I'm working from home.
Sure you are. Save up to 25% when you bundle home and auto with Allstate.
Your local Allstate agent is Steve Taub in media. Give him a call at 610-566-3500.
This is Keith Jackson. You're listening to High School Football right here on Haven Football.
Your car is probably your second biggest investment. An AMF Auto Clinic in Brookhaven wants to keep that investment in tip-top shape. AMF Auto Clinic has been maintaining automobiles since 1961, and they take pride in their work and in keeping your car in perfect running order. From inspections to general maintenance and repair, you can trust your auto investment to AMF Auto Clinic in Brookhaven. Call for an appointment today at 610-872-2167.
Hi, everyone. This is Greg Murphy from the Phillies broadcast team, where high school football never sounded so good, right here at havenfootball.net.
Welcome back to the District 1 5A title game. Chester and Strathaven ready to rock and roll here on Thanksgiving weekend. And we're glad you're joining us either live or on the archive. Andrew Kaufman promises we'll have score updates from next week's potential opponent for either of these teams as Delaware Valley up in Coal Country hosting Imhotep in the District 1, well, sorry, the state quarterfinal essentially. Today's 5A District 1 final essentially serves as a state quarterfinal game. The winner moves on to the state semis next weekend, which will be hosted by District 1. We do not have a date and time yet, but if I had to bet a nickel, it'll be Friday night somewhere here in Delaware County, if possible. But in the meantime, Chester and Springfield, Strathaven, lots to decide. Right here in front of us with Deron Harris putting it on the tee at the 40-yard line. James Fisher stands deep to return for the Panthers at his 10-yard line, flanked to his left by Marco Kaufman. To his right is number four, Makai Clark. So Fisher, a big play threat every time he touches the football. Not too many teams have kicked it to him this year, but we'll see what Chester decides to do, approaching quickly and then backing off and spreading out. Is the Chester kickoff team and Deron Harris ready to go? And the District 5 final is underway. End over end kick's going to take a hop at the 25-yard line. This will be Makai Clark from the 18. Looking for running room, and Makai lowers the shoulder, bangs his way out to the 34-yard line, and that's where the Panther offense will get started. Strathaven offense looks like this. Your quarterback is a senior, Jake Kitchen. James Fisher and Marco Kaufman, your halfbacks. The fullback is Shane Green. He's over 1,000 yards on the season, as is Fisher. Marco A.J. Glavichick is your split end. Cole Miller, your tight end. When they use two tight ends, it'll be Sean Henry. Carter Law is your center. Gavin Pilson and Jackson Jeremiah, the guards. Will Luthold and Billy Brown, your bookend tackles. And the Panthers ready to rock and roll from the 34-yard line. Kitchen under center. First down give is to Shane Green. Up the middle for a couple. Give him the 36, maybe 37. And that's about it. Chester's defense to start. Up front, I don't know if it'll be a five- or six-man front. We'll see. But up front, you've got DeAndre P., Dominic Toy, Isaiah Payne, Wyke Riggins, and number 14 is Damon Fitzgerald. Your two inside linebackers are leading tacklers, Jarrell Palmer and Wayne Clark. Deron Harris and Quamir Cosby, the corners. Imaj Barrett and Shamar Williams are the safeties. On second and nine, back is Kitchen looking. Wheel flag route outside. It's Sean Henry going up to get it. Hauls it in inside the 50, and it's into Chester territory. Good delivery there from Kitchen. Gain of about 21 on the play, and a Panther first down. Well, that's one way to do it, get yep. things started. Sean Henry not coming into the offensive look until the last couple weeks, but he's had some big catches over the last month or so. Give it to Kaufman. He sheds a tackle, and into the secondary he goes, down to the 41-yard line. Met there on the stop by the outside backer over there. Stand up, young man. I couldn't see.
Imaj Barrett.
Imaj Barrett, okay. Imaj Barrett is a safety, but again, the way Chester will probably approach this is creep the safeties up. May have a five- or six-man front most of the day, something the Panthers are quite used to seeing over the years and how to defend the wing tee. They'll go to Kaufman one more time on second down and about four. He'll get maybe a yard, maybe to the 40, and that's about it. It'll bring up third down and about three. So clock ticks, 10:16 and counting to play here in quarter number one. Strathaven started at their 34-yard line. Picked up a first down a moment ago, and now looking at third and about four and a half, or three and a half. Two tight ends, Cole Miller to the near side, Sean Henry to the far side. Alexi Gustafson out of the lineup today for the Panthers. That one will sting on both sides of the football. On third down, they give it to James Fisher, follows his block, leans forward, and looks like he has a first down. Needed three, they'll give him four and move the sticks on the far sideline. Panthers getting things moving. With the wing tee down to the 36, and a fresh set of downs for the silver and black. Good push up front by this offensive line so far. Panthers know they need 3-4 yards at a time on every play. Trying to keep things moving in the right direction here. They have two tight ends again. Fisher the wing to the near side. They go sweep to the far side. Fisher turns a corner, stiff arms a man, and is shoved out of bounds nicely by number four, Shamar Williams. Williams shoves him out at about the 30. Gain of six more on the play. Second down and four. James Fisher popped a 62-yard scoring run that turned out to be the difference in last week's win over Springfield. Comes into today as the Panthers' leading rusher with 1,239 yards, 18 scores on the ground by alone. Split end to the near side is Sean Henry. Fisher goes in motion. They give behind it to Shane Green, and he is belted. Absolutely smacked by Jarrell Palmer. Nice work there by Palmer, filling in the hole quickly and turns it into third down and about two or three. We'll see where they...
Third and three.
Okay.
Ball at the 29-yard line.
Shane Green also had a big week in the Springfield game a week ago, 18 carries for 145 yards. He's your fullback behind Kitchen here. Wing to the far side, hard count, and it looks like Chester's going yep. to give them a free five. Chester's had some trouble in recent weeks, especially double-digit penalties in the last several games, and this one will give the Panthers first and 10 at the Clipper 24-yard line, 8:42 and counting to play in quarter number one. Strathaven nearing the edge of the red zone here on the first possession of the game. Tight end to the far side, Cole Miller. Henry to the near side, wing to the right is Kaufman. Now he shifts into the backfield. They give to Kaufman off that left side again. Follows a block from Pilsen. He'll bump his way down near the 20, just shy of the 20 for about three. Second down and seven upcoming. Marco Kaufman, nine rushing touchdowns on the season, 589 yards, averaging almost 6 yards a carry.
Yeah, well, you know, the Panthers are very contented to run the ball like this, which is exactly what Springfield did last week. But they're very content to get these 3 and 4 yards a play.
Looking for more here. Second down and seven. 10 in the box for the Clippers. They give it to Shane Green. He lowers the shoulder, drives the pile for a few more inside the 20 to maybe the 18. We'll see where they put it down after they unpile. Ball carrier, third down upcoming.
Reading five.
And And call it third and maybe three or four. Looks like that far.
Third and four, ball the 18-yard line.
Panthers need the 14 for a first down. As Coughlin, as Green rather, picks up three. Third down upcoming. Two downs to get 4 yards here if you're the Panthers, and you're going to get flags pre-snap again. And let's see. You're going to get, is this against
Chester?
Got a
there,
dead ball, pre-snap offsides again against Chester.
That'll be a first
and it'll
down.
Be the second first down really of this drive that Strathaven's picked up via penalty. So another 5 yards here for the Panthers, down to a 13-yard line. Clock continues to melt here on the first quarter. We're inside of 7 minutes to go here in quarter number one as Kitchen jogs in the play.
Well, you know, this can happen on defensive line because as they feel they're getting beaten, pushed back, they want to try to get to the blocker first, and it causes them to lunge a little bit before that ball goes.
Two tight ends again. Wing T behind Kitchen. They give it to James Fisher. Running room momentarily. He'll lean his way forward inside the 10-yard line. Down to about the 8. Maybe 5 more here for Fisher. And the Panthers have to feel good about this first series. Jarrell Palmer, leading tackler for the Clippers. He is in on another one right there. 141 tackles, 19 tackles for loss for the 5'10 sophomore wearing number 6 today. Lots and lots of underclass talent for the Clippers. And trying to get a stop here on second down and 5. Kitchen on the rollout, looking, has time. He's going to keep it himself. Turns the corner off the left edge. He steps out of bounds. We'll see where. He's going to be very close to first down yardage, I think a hair shy. We'll see where they put it down on that far sideline.
Looks like it's about the 5-yard line.
He'll turn it to third and two. Okay.
Panthers the 3-yard line.
Yep, can pick up a first down here if they'd like, but 6 points would be better if you're a fan of Strathaven and 5 yards away from doing just that. Third and two. Again with two tight ends. Shane Green, your fullback behind Kitchen. They go keeper. Kitchen drives the pile forward. I think he's got first down yardage, and he's got touchdown yardage. Jake Kitchen in from the 5. Panthers on the board first with 5:59 to play here. In the first quarter, what a drive for the Panthers. They go 66 yards to pay dirt on the opening drive.
Used up almost exactly half. They're at 5:59 o'clock, so just slightly more than half of the first period, of the first quarter time.
On for the extra point, Ben Milligan. Jackson Miller to snap. Kitchen takes a knee. He spots. Kick is away. Plenty of leg and good. Strathaven 7. Chester, nothing but getting the football back when we come back in just a moment on havenfootball.net.
Looking for pre-K child care with an emphasis on learning? Ducklings Early Learning Center is available for children 6 weeks to 5 years old within one block of Nether Providence Elementary School on Moore Road in Wallingford. At Ducklings, our college-educated teachers create a safe, nurturing educational environment in our beautiful facility. Call Ducklings today for an appointment at 610-936-9400.
This is Merrill Reese, voice of the Philadelphia Eagles, where high school football never sounded so good, right here at havenfootball.net.
Strathaven 7, Chester nothing after one drive to start the game here. Chester ready to get the football for the first time, and half the first quarter is gone. 5:59 to play here in the opening stanza. Strathaven with a 66-yard scoring drive, 3 carries for each of the 3 backs, 2 carries for Jake Kitchen, and 1 completion to Sean Henry. That's a 12-play, 66-yard scoring drive, and the Panthers could not ask for a better start right there.
Yeah, very clean, no mistakes. Chester had a couple of offsides, cost, you know, gave him some first downs. I mean, Chester's got to tighten up their defense a little bit. On the other hand, Haven just was perfect.
Ian Gallagher has it teed inside the far hash, ready to kick it away. Kamir Cosby and Deron Harris await. It'll be Cosby fielding it, juggling it at the 20-yard line. Scramble for it, and let's see. Cosby does pounce on it at about the 25-yard line, so Cosby does well to corral it. They'll put the football down on the 26-yard line, and Chester gets the offense on the field. Chester's offense today led by sophomore quarterback Jalen Harris. Junior tailback is Larry McDaniel. We'll see a trio of other backs, Nareem Melvin, Jarrell Palmer, and Shamar Williams from time to time. Deron Harris is your split end, as is Damon Fitzgerald. Dom Toy's your tight end. Damon Moore at center. Zane Tillery and Jalen Johnson are the guards. The tackles, Jerry Young and Isaiah Payne. Split end to the far side is Imaj Barrett, motion man Fitzgerald, pistol look here, and on first down they go with a slant over the middle and loose in the secondary. Pulling away is Harris at the 30, 20, and it's Harris to Harris for 74 and a score. Chester with a chance to tie or take the lead.
Wow.
Beautiful delivery from Jalen to Deron. And the Panthers methodical in their 66-yard drive. Chester with a quick strike here, trailing 7-6, and now will go for two to try to take a lead. Chester has not attempted a place kick extra point all season long. They'll keep the offense on the field. And a 74-yard scoring strike to start the day. Hard to argue right there.
Yep.
From a Chester's perspective. And now they bunch everybody together, flat T formation, McDaniel, Palmer, and Shamar Williams in the backfield behind Jalen Harris. Two-point try upcoming, with a chance to take the lead. Harris turns. This is Williams off the left side, and he is wrapped up, and no signal. And he is shy of the goal line. Extra point, no good. 7-6 is where we stay. We'll take another short timeout, see if Travis Strathaven can answer. Just 16 seconds later, and the scoreboard shifts again. Be back in a moment. You're listening to this District 1 final on HavenFootball.net.
Looking to start an exciting career in the healthcare field? Then Keystone Quality Transport is looking for you. Keystone Quality Transport, the region's premier non-emergency medical transportation company, offers a full scholarship into a comprehensive emergency medical technician certification program. Would you like to obtain a National Registry Emergency Medical Technician certification and earn $20 per hour to start? Send an email to hr@kqthealth.com. Start your rewarding healthcare career today.
This is Keith Jackson reminding you you're listening to High School Football right here on havenfootball.net.
Yeah.
Welcome back to Chester High School. Chester strikes quickly, but the extra point try falls short on the two-point try. Strathaven 7, Chester 6, with 5:43 to go here in the first quarter. 74 yards on one play, 16 seconds off the clock, and Strathaven set to receive a kickoff for the second time here in the early going. Short kick comes to Makai Clark, and he is banged out of bounds here. Jarrell Palmer with the big hit, but good field position for the Panthers. It'll be out near the 40-yard line. Makai Clark sets up the offense for their second possession of the game at the 38-yard line. So 5:39 to go in the first quarter. And go ahead, Andrew.
Quick update from the 6A semifinal. St. Joe's Prep up on Nazareth 7-0.
Okay. We'll try to get a Del Valle and Imhotep score as things go in the other 5A quarterfinal. Here, double wing this time for the Panthers. Chester shows blitz, and Kaufman shakes a tackle, juggles the football. It did come loose, but I think he held on, pinned it to his leg, and does squeeze forward for about 3 yards, and slapping the ground in frustration. Larry McDaniel almost stripped that away and caused the first turnover of the game. But gain of 4 on the play for Kaufman brings up second down and 6 for Strathaven. Turnovers will be a key here. In probably their signature win of the season, Chester forced 3 Downingtown West turnovers in the win that vaulted them to the top seed here in the 5A bracket. On second down and 6, rather, give is to James Fisher, and he is undercut by number 4, Shamar Williams, just as Fisher was starting to turn it upfield and get going. He is chopped down at the line of scrimmage for no gain.
And he had some green in front of him for that one.
If Williams misses him, Fisher's probably still running. Instead, 3rd and 6. Panthers now trying to convert Chester trying to force a three and out after giving up a 66-yard scoring drive to open the game. Trying to grab the momentum that they seemed to get a moment ago on the long scoring pass. Here we go on third and six. Fisher, Kitchen back to pass. Has time. Fires outside. Coming back to the football. Fisher steps away for one man. Stiff arm. 30, 25. Carrying tacklers. Ball came out again. Boy, does Chester rip at the football, but it lands right underneath Fisher all the way down to the 21-yard line. Another big gain for the Panthers. And they're at the edge of the red zone again. 37. Kitchen to Fisher on the wheel route. Well, two passes, two long completions here for the Panthers, and Fisher, the all-purpose threat, lines up wing to the left behind Sean Henry here on first and 10 from the 21. Again, 10 in the box for the Clippers, and they shift Fisher to the backfield. They'll give it to Shane Green, looking for him off the left side, explodes into the secondary, cuts it back, first down yardage and more, and Shane Green inside the 10 to about the 8. 32. Shane Green gets loose there. His first three carries went for just 7 yards.
Great block. He
this
sealed
one
it off.
Down to the 7 for 14 more. Panthers 4 cracks at it now from the 7. Moving the football well. Still a huge crowd of people trying to get into this game on both sides behind us. First and goal. It's Green off the right side. He's met there by number 53. Isaiah Payne on the tackle. Pushes it down to about the 5. Second and goal from the 2.
My goodness, the line is like the length of the football field.
Both sides.
On both sides.
Yeah, so again, we tried to tell people get here early. It's going to be a packed house, and it will be.
I'm assuming it's the scanners they're using for the ticket situation is slowing things
up.
That's
part of it. All right, here we go. Lots of action so far here in this first quarter. Panthers second and goal from the 5. 3 minutes to go. Here in quarter number 1, Shane Green is your fullback. Kaufman alongside of him. Kitchen with a hard count. Good discipline from Chester, and now you're going to get flinching on the left side of the line. I think Strathairn is going backwards here. Dead ball, false start after two offside penalties from Chester in the first drive of the game. The Panthers have their first penalty, and it'll take it back to the 10. Second and goal to go.
So that's the kind of mistake that can just kill the drive.
Especially down here in the red zone, you've got second and goal from the 5, and now you've got second and goal from the 10.
Yeah, now you need about 3.5 yards a carry instead of 1.5.
Right.
All right, here we go. The Panthers will try again. Second and goal from the 10, again with two tight ends and a wing tee behind Kitchen. It's Fisher off the right side, looking for room, cuts it back, nothing doing. Yeah. Excellent job by Cosby to hold the edge, and he actually comes up with the tackle after it all shakes out. Gain of maybe a yard for Fisher. Third and goal from the 9, and now you've got a Panther on the ground. And looks like Cole Miller. This would be big problem if he can't go. Panthers already thinned out at tight end without Alexi Gustafson today, and now Cole Miller, your outstanding defensive tackle and maybe the best blocking tight end in the league this year, he's having trouble. All right, we're going to take a short timeout. Hope for the best for Big 40. We're going to keep it right here then. All right, Miller's
he's hurt,
having some trouble, but we'll keep it right here, Andrew.
And we'll add a couple of score updates in the 6A final. St. Joe's Prep off on Nazareth now 14-0, 7:47 to go in the first quarter. Imhotep fumbles the ball away. Delaware Valley recovers it and returns it for a touchdown. 7-0 Delaware Valley.
Wow. Okay.
With 8:56 to play in the first quarter up there.
All right. Here, fast-moving first quarter. Strathaven thinning out at tight end now.
Well, Chester's only had one play from scrimmage.
Right. And now the Panthers, without Alexi Gustafson, now Cole Miller hobbles off. It's Jahi Curtis checking in at tight end to the near side. Sean Henry now split end to the far side. Slot left is Fisher. Third and goal from the 9. Kaufman in motion. Back is Kitchen. He fires to the flat looking for Fisher. Overthrown, incomplete. And the Panthers now decision time from the 9-yard line. You'd be looking at a 27-yard field goal or so. And it looks like that's where they're headed. Ben Milligan jogs onto the field. And the Panthers, I believe, lining up to try to stretch their lead to 4 points. All right, Milligan 1 for 2 on field goals this year. puts the tee down at the 17-yard line. It'll be Jackson Miller to snap it. Jake Kitchen to hold. Milligan was kicking it well at this end of the field in pregame. Here, snap is a good one. Ball spotted, kick is away. Plenty long enough, and it is wide left. No good. Hooked it to the left. Panthers come up empty on that drive, and now Chester will get the football back at their 20-yard line. So the Panthers moved it well. Another big pass completion got them going, but that penalty at second and goal from the five is a killer.
That was hurtful.
Changes the entire complexion of the play calling there. Second and goal from the 5 versus second and goal from the 10.
Now, Haven has to see if they can play some defense here.
All right. Chester has run one offensive play. It was a 74-yard touchdown strike the first time they touched it. Now they set up right in the middle of the field at the 20-yard line, and it's Jalen Harris. Your sophomore quarterback has fellow junior Larry McDaniel behind him in the pistol. On first down, it's McDaniel looking for running room, and he'll find a couple across the 20 to about the 22. We can get to the Strathaven defense. I don't know if you have that graphic ready. We'll get that maybe after this play.
Okay.
Or we can get it after this play, but a couple of changes already as Bill Brown has checked in on the defensive line in place of Cole Miller with 1:32 to go here in quarter number one. 7-6, Strathaven clinging to a one-point lead with obviously a long way to go in this one. Jalen Harris again in the gun. McDaniel on his right hip. And they'll go with a jet sweep to the near side. Looking for room is Deron Harris. He makes one man miss, two men miss. Shake and bake to the near side. And Ben Milligan finally spins him down across the 35 out to the 37. Good pursuit there from Jahi Curtis as well. But Deron Harris is a threat every time he touches the football. And 14 yards later, it's a Chester first down.
Yeah, that was a great run. You want to do defense?
Sure. Panther defense today. Up front, Jahi Curtis, Cole Miller, Nick Farabaugh, and Vince Hales. And already Bill Brown's replaced Cole Miller, who's out with an injury at the moment. Henry, Kaufman, and Green are your linebackers. Glavicek and Schuster on the corners. Milligan and James Fisher are your safeties. On first and 10 from the 37, draw play. Looking for room. McDaniel gets a block, and then Jahi Curtis swallows him up at about the 41. But a nice first down gain for the Clippers. Gain of 5 for McDaniel. Larry McDaniel coming in, 85 carries, 529 yards, and 6 touchdowns on the season. 2 100-yard games to his credit, one of them a week ago in the semifinal victory over Ruston, where he had 121 yards and a touchdown. McDaniel, 2 carries for 7 yards in the early going here. Second and 5 for the Clippers from their 42. Under center, perhaps. Now shifting to the gun once again is Jalen Harris. Toy and Deron Harris are your wings. On second and 5, one more time, McDaniel. Straight ahead, looking room off the left side, shedding tackles, running hard into Strathaven territory to the 45-yard line on what will be the final play of the first quarter. Gain of 13 for McDaniel. Chester on the move and with momentum as we begin quarter number 2, I believe. It should be the end of the quarter. Yes, okay. Everybody else caught on. Here we go. We'll take a short timeout. Be back for quarter number 2, the District 1 5A Final. Glad you joined us live on the archive on havenfootball.net.
Have nagging soft tissue injury, chronic joint pain? Give Rose Tree Wellness Center a call and see Dr. Tom O'Brien for a complete diagnosis and treatment. Dr. O'Brien specializes in active release techniques, ART. ART can deal with many issues, including chronic shoulder, knee, and ankle pain. Rose Tree Wellness Center also offers a complete series of massage therapy as well as general chiropractic care. Don't spend another day in pain. Call 610-789-5555 and make an appointment today.
This is Merrill Reese, voice of the Philadelphia Eagles, where high school football never sounded so good, right here at havenfootball.net.
Welcome back to not far from the campus of Chester High School here at the Field House. Brian Carroll bringing play-by-play. Andrew Coffin and Mike Mayer joining me. Mike Clancy on the camera. Strathaven 7, Chester 6 here at the end, or really the start of the second quarter. Clippers on the move here after Strathaven drove it well but came up a little bit wide on a field goal attempt. Instead now the Clippers trying to get things going here from the Panther 45 as we start this second quarter. Split to the near side, Zabri. He goes in motion to the left, and on first down, the give one more time is to McDaniel, and Bill Brown into the backfield. Forward progress, I think, generously gives him the line of scrimmage, but Bill Brown shooting through and making the stop. They'll lose maybe a half yard. Second down and 10 and a half upcoming. Nice work there by Brown, getting off his block. And Chester, as we mentioned in the pregame, a much more balanced attack this year in terms of pass to run ratio. And even without their leading rusher in the lineup today, looking to do well here. And now it looks like Dominic Toy lined up slot to the near side. And looks like he was offsides. No flag coming. They fire to the near side. Good catch off the shoe tops by number 14. That's Damon Fitzgerald for a gain of 6. Toy was, even with the Chester fans.
Lined up over the football.
Chester fans in front of us saying, back up. He was dangerously close to an offside penalty there. But a gain of 6 here for McDaniel. Turns it to third down and 4. Harris, 2 out of 2 throwing it so far. From the Strathaven 39. Slot to the left is Fitzgerald. To the near side, Deron Harris singled up with A.J. Glavicek at the bottom of your screen. They give inside. This is looking for running room and near first down yardage. I think he has it. This is Larry McDaniel for 4 and a first down. Nice tackle in the open field there by Marco Kaufman. Kaufman, the leading tackler for the Panthers, comes in with 140 tackles on the season. 149, rather. 7 for loss. He's had a monster of a year as a senior linebacker. 4 wide this time, pistol look. And on first and 10, they play fake and rolling to his left, and in trouble is Jalen Harris. Nice stiff arm to get away from one man, and Shane Green finally shoves him out of bounds. Good work there by Jahi Curtis to disrupt, and a good job also by Harris to fend him off with a stiff arm. Gain of 2, second down and 8 upcoming.
Now, this is quite a defensive battle. I mean, I know we've got scoring, but these teams are pretty equal with each other.
Yeah, not surprising. Panthers, you know, we talked about the Chester defense allowing only 11 points per game. That was 4th best in District 1. Panthers not far behind, 10th best, average allowing only 13 per game. High snap on 2nd down and 8. Stretch play to this near side and turning upfield, McDaniel. Shoestring tackler, he'd be still on his way to pay dirt perhaps, but tripped up at the 28-yard line, turns it to 3rd down and about 3. So McDaniel, 6 carries, 27 yards unofficially here in the early going. Clock ticks, 9:43, 9:42 and counting to play here in the first half. Chester trailing 7-6, looking for the lead. Chester, 3 receivers bunched to the right here for Jalen Harris. Single to the far side is his twin brother, and they give inside on the counter, and Jahi Curtis blew it up once again. Great job by Curtis to hold up the blocker, and then coming in to clean up is Marco Kaufman and Bill Brown. Kaufman and Brown dropping back at the 30-yard line. It's suddenly 4th and 5, loss of a yard on the play. Panther defense needs a stop.
Excellent push there on the inside from Bill Brown.
Yeah, Haven's starting to get a feel for what's going on here, and Chester's going to have to adapt, but right now this is a huge play for both teams.
4th and 5, Amaj Barrett split to the far side. Dom Toy to the near side. Motion man goes Deron Harris. He resets as a wing to the right. On 4th and 5, Jalen Harris, hard count, Panthers jump, and it looks like it'll be another first down. Yep. So Chester with 2 offside penalties on the opening drive. Then the Panthers have now returned it with a false start back down at the 5-yard line. And here on 4th and 5, Chester gets a first down without needing to snap it. Fresh set of downs for the orange and black here at the 25-yard line. Cole Miller back into the game here in place of Bill Brown. Shotgun look once again for Jalen Harris on 1st and 10. Williams slot to the right. He looking left, and now you're going to get flags first and false start, I believe.
Yep.
All right. Chester, I think, returned the favor, but boy, what a difference on fourth and five versus first and ten.
Yeah.
They returned the favor, but a down too late.
With an IOU, I think.
Yeah. So another pre-snap penalty here for the Clippers, I believe. We're still waiting for a signal. And the officials are talking about maybe some post-play extracurriculars. All right. They'll march off the five. Dead ball, false start. Okay. 8:26 to go here in the second quarter. Strathaven 7-6, leading by a thread. Three receivers to the left this time, one to the right for Jalen Harris. Larry McDaniel on his right hip. First and 15, Harris fires to the outside, juggled and caught by Dom Toy. The juggle actually helped him right there. The Panthers were closing, and Toy picks it out of the air and is dumped at the 20-yard line as Ben Milligan makes the stop. First catch of the day for Dom Toy. Put it down at the 19 for a gain of 11. Second down and call it four, maybe. Yep.
Second and four.
Jalen Harris, three out of three throwing it. Toy, his first catch of the day. He's the leading receiver coming into the game for the Clippers. And now 7:35 and counting to play here in the second quarter. Barrett to the far side. Fitzgerald to the bottom of your screen. Slot to the right is Daron Harris. His brother Jalen in the shotgun on second down and four. Give is to McDaniel. He dances his way off the left side for a couple.
Running the ball, number one.
Couple more there for McDaniel. Panthers swarm quickly. It's Kaufman and Vince Hales in the mix.
He slipped
for the tackle.
Slipped when he got the handoff, which probably screwed up the timing.
Just a couple for Larry McDaniel. 28 yards on eight carries there for the junior tailback. Third and about two here for Chester. Panther defense really needs two plays here. Four down territory for sure for the Clippers. Dom Toy at the bottom of your screen to the near side. Harris goes in motion. They roll that way. Jalen Harris with time, looks, fires back across his body to the middle field. Jump ball to the end zone, swatted away. Incomplete, knocked out of harm's way by Ben Milligan. And A.J. Glavicek in the mix as well. Fourth and two, and, you know, that's, from a Chester standpoint, that's not maybe a bad idea. Take a shot in the end zone and say, hey, we think we can get fourth and two here. A little bit of a dangerous throw there from Harris. But
the danger, obviously, is he gets tipped into the wrong hands.
Now fourth and two. Chester trying to convert with 6:34 to go here before halftime. Timeout on the field. It looks like Strathaven will want to talk things over their first time out of the half. So we'll take a short timeout with them. Thanks again to our fantastic sponsors who keep us going every week on havenfootball.net.
Selling or buying a home is serious business. And for serious business, the key to your success is to work with an experienced agent. Sandy McCulley has over 20 years of real estate experience and is a seller representative specialist as well as a certified residential specialist. Sandy specializes in Delaware County real estate. Sandy conveniently works out of the Media Berkshire Hathaway Home Marketing Center and Media. Let Sandy's experience be your advantage in today's multifaceted real estate market. Give Sandy a call at 610-368-6641.
This is Merrill Reese, voice of the Philadelphia Eagles, and you're listening to high school football right here on havenfootball.net.
Welcome back to the District 1 5A championship game, Strathaven 7, Chester 6. But the Clippers threatening right here. Fourth and two from the Strathaven 17-yard line. Panthers needing a stop in a big way. Chester's a few moments ago had fourth and five, and the Panthers jumped off sides and gave them a free first down. Chester trying to earn another one right here.
Gotta say, stay disciplined on that D-line.
Two wide receivers to the left. Two to the right. On fourth and two, it's Jalen Harris with Dom Toy to his right. His brother Duran goes in motion to the left, and now he'll get somebody flinched again. And I think this is on Chester here.
Yes.
Dead ball foul will turn this to fourth and seven. Illegal procedure against the orange and black. Ouch. Well, fourth and seven indeed, and back to the 22-yard line. Chester with a self-inflicted wound right there. The Panthers trying to take advantage on fourth and seven.
Score update, St. Joe's Prep extends our lead to 21.
21-0 over Nazareth, and not saying that that's terribly surprising in that 6A quarterfinal. All right, here we go. Fourth and seven for Chester. Jalen Harris perhaps changing the play. Back judge with his hand in the air, counting it down, counting down the play clock, and then Dennis Shaw, nice job there by Coach Shaw, calling timeout here just in time as the back judge was counting down the play clock. Chester's first time out of the half comes at a key moment here on fourth down and seven. So we'll keep it right here. And Mike, it's been as advertised. We thought this would be a tight one, and you know, see who can minimize mistakes.
And you know, we thought it'd be tight enough to where these kind of mistakes, the offsides, the being drawn offsides, the illegal procedures, can be devastating to these drives. And that's exactly what we've got. You know, it's bad enough it happens when you're on your own 30 or so, but when you're down on your opponent's 30 and you're 2 yards from a first down, or in Strathaven's case,
10.
Where they're inside the 10 and ready, you know, they got whatever is first and goal, second and goal. That 10-yard penalty is just a killer. So it was a 5-yard penalty.
Yeah,
actually, wasn't
but,
it? Yeah,
but it took him back to the 10-yard line. Yeah. Total game changer right there, and turns into a missed field goal attempt instead of maybe an 8-point lead. So we'll see here what Strathaven and can come up with defensively here to try to stop a fourth and seven. Chester just used its first time out, has drawn something up now with three wide receivers to the right of Jalen Harris. On fourth and seven, looking, firing to the near side. Deron Harrison in coverage is James Fisher. Incomplete. And then a flag comes in very late. Wow. They got the official closest to the play did not call a foul. But then the official on the near side, 30 yards behind the play, called it. Now, is this going to be it may not be interference. It could be a sideline warning.
Oh, you threw it towards the play, though.
Yeah, but or is it a sideline warning against Chester? I'm not sure. All right, let's see.
It's got to be an awful lot of conversation for a sideline warning.
James Fisher singled up out there with Deron Harris, and you're going to get pass interference, Strathaven. On a call with just one-on-one coverage. And again, take your shot, Chester, with your best receiver perhaps. And again, coming back for the football. Nice job there by Deron Harris to come back for it. And now it'll be first down, or is it fourth? Yeah, first and goal. Half the distance to the 11-yard line. No, it's outside the 10. Should be first and 10. Okay.
Yeah.
Should be first and 10 from the 11. All right, they're resetting the chains over there. All right, and now you're going to get a flag and let's see.
So it's first down, first and 10.
Okay. Now you're going to another dead ball and another false start here against Chester. All right, so they'll back it up to the 16. So a penalty-filled first quarter here.
First half.
Well, yeah, that's right.
We're halfway through the second quarter.
Halfway through that second quarter. It's been a game of many stops and starts here with 6:26 to go here in quarter number two. Chester will try again now at the 17-yard line. All right, here we go. Jalen Harris in the gun again on first and 15. Looking to his right on first 15, loses his footing momentarily, steps up in the pocket, eyes downfield, throws back across his body, incomplete. Looking for his brother Deron near the goal line. Pass delivered just a bit high and brings up second down and 15. Clock stops with 6:20 to go here in regulation, or in the second quarter.
Still regulation,
yeah,
I guess.
Well, yeah. Okay.
But I
usually save that for the fourth quarter.
Right, no, I understand.
One of these times we'll get it right. This this daytime football's got me a little off
daytime
kilter.
Football
here.
Throws us all off.
Couldn't ask for a better day, though.
Our first game on grass this year. Our first game in the daytime. It's fantastic. All right. Second and 15. Jalen Harris back to pass once again. Nope, they go with a jet sweep to the far side. Deron Harris dances away from one man, two men. Ball comes out, but out of bounds first. And Harris down near the 10-yard line, I believe. We'll see when they walk it off the sideline. It'll be third down. And
looks like at the 9.
Are they putting this down where?
At the 9.
Okay. All right, so you're looking at third and about 6 or 7.
8 or 9.
Where are they putting? Are they at the 1-yard line? All right. Okay.
Yeah, first down, because it was first and goal, first and 10 from the 11. Okay. They need the 1.
Third and call it 8. Jalen Harris. With Zaheem Sabri to his right, they give to McDaniel back to the left. Panther defense swarms. Nice work there by Nick Faribault and Jahi Curtis to swallow him up. Short gain, and you're looking now at fourth down and an injured Chester
Clipper on the play.
And this is Deron Harris.
Deron Harris. And that actually looks like kind of a direct snap-ish.
Yeah.
Did it lose
kind of
yardage?
A miscommunication.
What do you have him done for a
yard? Yeah, he did lose a yard there.
Yep.
They're going to spot this back at the 10, and now the concern is for Deron Harris.
Yep.
A do-everything Clipper as a corner, as a receiver.
He's a
kicker.
He is your return man. And now, with the clock stopped due to his injury, he has to come off the field for this fourth down play.
Right.
So Deron Harris will come off, and now fourth and 9 for the Clippers. They converted a fourth down a few moments ago on an offside penalty. They converted another fourth down on a pass interference penalty. And here,
clock restarts.
Clock continues to run now. We're at 5:50 and counting to go here in quarter number 2. Clippers have not attempted a place kick all season. They'll forego it right here. Fourth and about 9. Chester. Sends Sabri in motion right to left. Looking right is Harris. Steps up in the pocket. Dances outside. He breaks containment. Turns upfield. He's looking for the goal line. Schuster shoves him out, but I think he's in first. And waiting for the signal, he's in. Touchdown, Chester. As Jalen Harris on the 10-yard scramble just inside the pylon. Panthers lost containment on the edge. And the Clippers make them pay with 5:27 to go here in quarter number 2. 12-7, and extra point pending here. Two-point conversion pending, really.
I mean, at the end of the day, win or lose, I mean, Chester is making the plays they have to make, and that's what this game is all about. You know, he went back. Coverage was great for Strathaven. Nobody was open. We had him contained and then lost containment, and he made it all the way in the end zone.
That little pump fake had the defensive ends leaving his feet to knock it down, and Harris turns the corner for 10 and a score. Trying to stretch a lead to 7 here are the Clippers. T formation. Give inside. Jarrell Palmer going absolutely nowhere. Panthers have swallowed up two-point conversions. And try is no good. 12-7. Chester on top for the first time today. 5:27 to go in quarter number 2. Back in just a moment on havenfootball.net.
Do you have slow-running drains? Are you thinking about selling your home or property? If so, go to scarpignatoplumbing.com. and schedule a technician. They are the area's only small plumbing company to offer in-house trenchless sewer and water main repairs. They also offer sewer lateral certifications for the surrounding communities. From faucets to water heaters, they can handle all your plumbing needs. Give them a call at 484-832-5566.
This is Keith Jackson reminding you you're listening to High School Football right here on havenfootball.com.
Strathaven on the wrong end of a 12-7 score now. 5:27 to go here in the District 1 5A final. Chester leading in quarter number 2 here. Jalen Harris caps the drive with a 10-yard quarterback keeper, a scramble.
And, number 8 on the kickoff.
Cashing in.
Shadrick George.
Okay, Shadrick George ready to kick it away here in place of Deron Harris, and he shanks it off the front side of his foot here, and a nice job by Farabaugh to grab it, and the Panthers was excellent field position. That was not an intentional onside kick, but it'll serve the purpose for the Panthers. Good field position. They'll start at their 45. Well, Mike, I'll finish up a tweet here.
Okay. Well, this has been everything that we all were looking for. We expected a great game between two very evenly matched teams, and it has certainly been all that in the first half. If Haven can go down and score before the end of the quarter, that would put this thing, within a couple of points. So we'll see what happens.
All right, Panthers. From their 46-yard line, Jake Kitchen turns, and they go counter crisscross looking for room. Is James Fisher pulling away now? 30, 25, 20. Fisher is caught from behind, and down he goes at the 10-yard line where the Panthers rip off a bundle. 44 for James Fisher on counter crisscross.
There aren't many people that can catch up with James Fisher when he gets off like that.
Nice job by Larry McDaniel to save the touchdown momentarily, but Fisher rips down off his longest run of the day. Panthers
12.
Back at the, okay, at the 12.
Strathaven can get a first down.
All right, here we go. Panthers first and 10 from the 12-yard line. It's Fisher one more time, looking for room off the right side. He'll not find much of it. Second effort will take him down to about the 9. Gain of 3, second down and 7. All right. Now they're going to move him down to
the 8.
Oh,
let's see.
This looks like
yeah, that's about the 8.
Okay, we'll call it 4. All right, clock ticks. 4:30 and counting to play here. In.
And they are still waiting in big numbers to get into this game.
On second down and 8, it's Green off the left side. He'll lean forward and met there by number 7, Kamir Cosby, and others. Green down to the 5. Panthers turn it to third down in about 2 or so.
Third and 3.
33 maybe.
They need the 2. You're
going to try to draw them off to frustrate the heck out of them?
We'll see. Two more cracks at it here. Four down territory for sure for the Panthers as they trail by 5 here with 3:48 and counting to go here in the second quarter. Two tight ends. For the Panthers again, it's Green off the right side this time. Leans forward, he's near first down yardage. I think a little shy. We'll see. It'll be awfully close. You're looking at first and goal or fourth and inches. And see where they spot it. Nose of the football near the 3. And
fourth down.
Fourth down and upcoming. All right.
Looks like 2 the way he set it up. We got timeout.
All right, clock ticks. Panthers.
Clock still runs.
Fourth.
Oh, official timeout.
They're going to measure.
They're going to measure.
Clock is still running, though. They've not stopped the clock for. Okay. There we go. There's your signal.
They'll need to reset that.
With 3:03 to go here before halftime. Panthers
first
getting
down.
A measurement,
nope.
And he is inches short. So. Panthers on fourth and short typically have gone quarterback sneak.
Yep.
It worked the first time today. Jake Kitchen
worked
had
for
the
five-yard
touchdown run. That was the Panthers' score on the opening drive of this football game. Panthers' next drive resulted in a missed field goal. Here, their third drive, knocking on the door one more time, trying to cash in here. Fourth down and inches from just outside the 3. Fans on their feet making some noise for the home team. Chester defense looking for a stop. It's Kitchen off the left side. He's got room. The first down and more in for the touchdown. Jake Kitchen for the second time today. Good push from the left side there. Pilsen and Bill Brown leading the way. Carter Law got a good push at center. And now Strathaven with a 1-point lead. Extra point pending.
Nope.
Now, I don't think they're chasing points just yet. As he'll get Ben Milligan back on for his second extra point try of the day. 2:54 to go here before halftime. Milligan on for the extra point. Miller to snap it. Kitchen puts it down. Kick plenty long enough and good. Milligan 2 for 2 on the extra points. Panthers lead it 14-12. On the seesaw we go back and forth. And we'll be back in a moment on havenfootball.net.
The Swarthmoreian Weekly Newspaper has partnered up with HavenFootball.net.
The Swarthmoreian was established in 1893 and is a true community newspaper and covers the Wallingford-Swarthmore School District as well as events in Swarthmore, Wallingford, and surrounding communities. Get your copy every Friday at 320 Market or Swarthmore Co-op or call 610-543-0900 for a mailed subscription. For all the local news, read the Swarthmoreian every week.
Hey fans, this is Todd Lights, public address announcer for the Los Angeles Dodgers, and you are listening to High School Football right here at Haven Football.
Welcome back to the District 1 5A championship game. Back and forth we've gone. Just as Chester grabs momentum, Strathaven steals it right back with a 54-yard scoring drive, aided by a short kickoff and a heads-up play from Nick Farabaugh to field it. A 42-yard run from James Fisher put them in the neighborhood, and Jake Kitchen's second touchdown run of the day, this one from 3 yards out on fourth and inches, has given the Panthers a 14-12 lead. The only difference right now, the extra point conversions. Panthers 2-for-2 kicking it. Chester 0-for-2 running the two-point tries. Ian Gallagher has it teed at the 40-yard line. Daron Harris back into the game. Good news for the young sophomore who hobbled off with an injury a few moments ago. But he stands deep along with Kamir Cosby at about the 15-yard line. Gallagher ready to go here with 2:54 to go here in the fourth quarter, or second quarter rather. Chester will receive the second half kickoff. So the Panther defense looking for a stop here. Chester would love points before halftime, of course. High short. End over end, short kick. It'll come down to Cosby at the 19. Looking for him up the hash mark. Bounces to the outside and not much doing. Good coverage that time by the Panther kick unit. Makai Clark in on the stop with Shane Green. And Cosby sets up the offense at the 31-yard line for the Clippers, 30-yard line maybe, for the Clippers with 2:48 to go before half. Chester, your Del Valle League champs at 12-1 on a 12-game win streak. And go ahead, Andrew. A
couple of quick score updates. End of the first quarter, St. Joe's Prep up on Nazareth, 28-0, 7-7. Delaware Valley and Imhotep tied.
Delaware Valley and Imhotep, the winner gets the winner of this one next Friday night, somewhere in District 1. Sabri motions and now comes to the slot at the far side. Shotgun, four wide receivers. Motion back to the near side for Sabri. Back to pass Harris. All sorts of time. Down the seam he goes. Wide open and making the catch is Nareem Melvin. First down at the moment, but there's a flag in the backfield. This is typically in the area of holding. And indeed, that is the call. And that's that one stings for the Clippers right there, as this will turn this into first and 25 way back in their own territory. Melvin looked like he had his first catch of the game out across the 45. Instead, Clippers, maybe that's why he had so much time to throw. I didn't see the hold either,
yeah. But I saw the flag come down in the backfield. I'm like, there was something happening there.
All right, so they'll move it back
to the
20-yard line.
First and 20.
Four wide receivers again. Daron Harris to the bottom of your screen. Sabri slot to this near side as well. And Jalen Harris awaits the whistle. We're ready to go once again. First and 20, the Clippers will try again. McDaniel in the backfield. And it's Harris, looks, draw play to McDaniel, looking for running room, runs into Cole Miller, who did a great job just standing his man up at the line of scrimmage. You'll end up with no gain at best here for the Clippers, and it'll turn it into second down and 20. Miller continues to hobble. Went out with an injury.
It was actually number five, Nareem Melvin, on the carry.
Melvin, okay. Good catch, Andrew. It'll bring up second down and 20. Chester may decide to play this fairly conservatively, knowing they're getting the football to start the second half, maybe now behind the sticks, unless you get a big play. Don't want to give Strathaven the football back before halftime if you don't have to. See what second and 20 brings. Harris back to pass. No rest for the weary here. He's looking, has a man out there, now he's going to keep it himself. Turns upfield and will step out of bounds, stopping the clock. James Fisher will get credit for the tackle, bumping him out of bounds near the 30, maybe just a hair shy of it. It'll be third down and about 11 with 1:41 to go here before halftime. And again, this is, you know, if the Panthers get a stop here, you're looking to get the football back before half with two timeouts in their pocket.
Depends on what happens on this play. You may take a timeout if they keep the clock running.
Three wide receivers to the near side. Top of the screen, empty. Harris now going to get a flag, and I think somebody flinched again. You're going to end up offside. Panthers,
wow.
Another free five here. It'll turn it to third down and six, something much more manageable perhaps for Chester. So Panthers are hurting themselves with penalties for sure today. And the same can be said for Chester.
Did somebody move or he just lined up?
He may have just lined up offside.
All right. To the top of your screen, Damon Fitzgerald to that far side. Trips left this time on third down and six. Jalen Harris awaits the shotgun snap with 1:40 to go in the second quarter. Fires down the seam. It goes. It's deflected away. Ben Milligan got a hand on it. Sean Henry in coverage as well. And now clock stopped with 1:36 to go. Decision time for the Clippers. You'd think he'd have to punt it away, right? But
I would think he could possibly.
Here comes Daron Harris. Looks to be the punt team.
Yep. Daron Harris will be your punter. He is hobbled at the moment. It'll be his twin brother, Jalen, your quarterback, to snap it. He's a long snapper, and the punt team has been a bit of an adventure for Chester this year.
And any reason to watch for a potential,
see if the
with Daron Harris being such an athlete, maybe some type of fake here?
Possible.
Yeah,
but
possibly.
We'll see here. Snap is a good one. Daron Harris steps into it and gets it away. Low line drive, angling towards Fisher, and takes a sideways roll. A Chester bounce to the Strathaven 34. Nice job by Daron Harris to tilt the field here. And the Panthers now with 1:28 to go before halftime have two timeouts and maybe a chance to add to a 14-12 lead. But This is the kind of spot here where the Chester defense has feasted. They've turned over many a team this season in passing situations or teams that get maybe a little too aggressive. So, Panthers,
is this a passing situation for the Panthers?
We'll see if they want to take a shot. I don't know. Still 10 in the box here for the Clippers. On first down, Basque to pass his kitchen. Looking, has a man out there. It's the post. It is Fisher incomplete. Was behind Melvin, but pass overthrown a bit with the wind suddenly picking up. And that one sailed a bit on Kitchen. His first incompletion of the day brings it to second down and 10. Had two men out in the pattern. Henry on the flag route and Fisher behind him on the post. Not a bad read necessarily, but the ball sailed a bit, and it's second down and 10. And
there was good coverage there from the Chester defense.
Yep. Would it needed a perfect throw. And again, wind has definitely picked up now at the Panthers' back here. They shift wing to the right is Kaufman. The give is to Fisher. Gets maybe a yard, and four white orange jerseys swallow him up quickly, led by Steve Dale Jr. And now timeout here for Chester with 1:13 to go, and they'll say, hey, we can maybe get the ball back with a stop. So there's your danger of taking your shot, right? You throw incomplete, clock stops, and now you need a third and nine conversion to make something happen as we're just 73 seconds from halftime. Speaking of halftime, we will have in front of us the Strathaven Marching Band. Phenomenal as always, and looking forward to another terrific performance. We'll show that. Should have a little time for some chatter as well after the band performance and maybe talk about the first half, talk about the potential opponent next weekend, and it's been a fun ride here. 12-1 are the Panthers, 12-1 are the Clippers. So anybody playing in week 14 of the high school football season really doesn't have any reason to complain. But at the same time, there are more than a couple seniors today who will be playing their last high school football game. We mentioned that at the beginning of every broadcast, and there's a bunch of kids out there that just don't want it to end yet. Long way to go in this one, and a long way to go for the Panthers. Now third down and 9 from their own 35. 1:13 to go here in quarter number 2. On the sweep to the right side, this is James Fisher looking for running room. Is near first down yardage, dives across the 45. If they give him the 46, that's enough. And Fisher picks up 12 and a first down. The Panthers make it on it in a hurry here. Clock stopped while they reset the chains. But Fisher rips off 13 more to the 46.
That was a heck of a play, heck of a run.
Fisher unofficially 70 yards rushing here. Sean Henry split to the bottom of your screen. Slot left is Fisher. Kitchen back to pass on first down. Heavy pressure coming. He wants it all. Down the near sideline, Daron Harris is out there. Has the interception. Fisher wraps him up. That'll essentially serve as a good punt, but Panthers not looking to punt it necessarily right there. And for the second week in a row, Daron Harris has himself an interception. Last week, he ran it back 70 yards for a touchdown to put it out of reach for Rustin. In this case, it kills the last Strathaven drive of the half with 36 seconds to go before halftime, and the 7th interception of the year for the sophomore defensive back. Daron Harris has been phenomenal. He'll spot the football at the 16-yard line, and that's Panthers. That's a big play by James Fisher to make that tackle. You do not want Daron Harris running loose in the open field. Instead now, Jalen Harris awaits the shotgun snap from his own 16. Just 36 seconds to go before halftime. Chester with one timeout remaining before half. Harris back, looking, and you're going to get snapped.
Pre-snap.
Pre-snap whistle yet again, and another false start here, I believe. Or no, they're going to reset. False start again. Okay. All right, March, the Clippers back another 5 yards. I don't know. We'll have to check at halftime the number of penalties at this point, but Clippers.
A lot.
Yeah, Clippers have been in double-digit penalties for several weeks, and they're on their way to that again. And Strathaven not far behind them today. They've had a couple costly ones as well, more than a couple.
11 in the first half. 7 for 11. Chester, 7 for Chester, 4 for Haven.
Yep. All right. Chester will try it again now. From their own 11-yard line with 34 seconds to go before half. They double the receiver at your bottom of your screen, Dom Toy. 3 receivers to the left. Looking to the right is Harris. He's in some trouble now. Dances away from 1 man, 2 men, and is wrapped up from behind. Vince Hales has got him at the 15-yard line. Maybe the line of scrimmage, if they're generous, I think it'll be, call it a loss of a half yard or so. So another sack for Vince Hales.
No, he got back to him.
Did they? They put it back?
The original line.
The original. I'm sorry, the original line. All right. 8 seconds to go here before halftime. It's McDaniel underneath the coverage with blockers in front. Stumbles momentarily. Still on his feet. And now going to turn it upfield. The clock says 0. The Panthers need a tackle. And it's Ben Milligan that will save the day. Shoving him out at the 40-yard line. And that will do it for the first half. I love the call there from Chester. See if they can spring a big play. McDaniel goes for 35, but Milligan shoves him out to end the first half. What a ball game we've had here. Choppy, mistake-filled to some degree, but 14-12. Can't complain about the entertainment value in this one so far. Hoping for 2 more good quarters, but in the meantime, we're going to hear from our sponsors. Thank you again for all of the folks who so generously donate at the beginning of the year and keep us on the live stream every week. And again, terrific in-person crowd as well. But if you're watching at home, live or on the archive, we thank you, and thank you for taking care of our sponsors in the local community. Be back in a moment. We'll step aside and be back for the halftime show momentarily right here on havenfootball.net.
Volunteer with South Media Fire Company, serving Nether Providence Township and Rose Valley Borough, where you and your unique skills and passions are wanted. Volunteering with South Media Fire Company isn't just about responding to emergency calls, it's about building lifelong connections. As a volunteer, you'll forge friendships that extend beyond the firehouse while serving your community. For more information, please visit us at southmediafire.com.
Hello, everyone. I'm Ron Jaworski, former Philadelphia Eagles quarterback, and you're listening to high school football right here on HavenFootball.net.
Harris, four for Jalen.
Yeah. We're back, guys.
Oh, welcome back. Thank you, Mike. All right. Well, we'll step aside. I mean, we're going to you might as well mute our mics and see if we can't pick up the field mic as Nick Pignataro will introduce the marching unit. And there is not a sound that Andrew, Mike, or I can make that's anywhere close to what you're about to see and hear right in front of us as the Strathaven Marching Band makes their way onto the field for the halftime show. So we will close our mouths for a few minutes and let everybody at home enjoy the sight and sound of the 2023 Strathaven Marching Band.
Sarah Ventriglia. It was 1977. The album was Rumors. Fleetwood Mac smashed the charts. And Yesterday's Gone. Yesterday's Gone. But this afternoon, Don't Stop. Football fields worldwide, including the Super Bowl halftime show, Bruno Mars combining drinking lyrics with twice the rhythms of this 2010 pop hit. Well, looky here, what do we have? This is Runaway Baby.
Thank you.
stop this feeling deep inside of me that the Panther Band is about to open up with a hit tune, Return to Fame, with the film Guardians of the Galaxy. Hooked on a feeling, on a blue sweep. Rock handle. We need a hero, and we're holding out for the hero to the end of the night. It's got to be strong, and it's got to be fast, and it's got to be the Panther Band with this Bonnie Tyler hit.
Thank you.
the 90s, the 2000s are back in 2023, and we're in our rock band glory. Say It Ain't So. This is Blink 182 with the Girl at the Rock Show and all the small things from the pride of Haven, the Strathaven High School Panther Marching Band. For the Panther Band, I'm Nick Nicotero. Have a great afternoon, and let's go the Panthers.
Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, give it up for Strathaven Band. Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, please put your hands together for the one, the only gentleman often talked about, the legendary.
Welcome to Allstate, where everyone saves when they bundle their home and auto insurance. Isn't that right, Frank?
I saved 25%. Booyah.
You protected your casa?
Sure did.
And the Frank tank?
You know it.
And now you're relaxing.
I'm working from home.
Sure you are. Save up to 25% when you bundle home and auto with Allstate.
Your local Allstate agent is Steve Taub in media. Give him a call at 610-566-3500.
This is Keith Jackson. You're listening to High School Football right here on HavenFootball.com.
Chester.
We're back.
Oh. Welcome back to the District 1 5A championship game. We're at halftime. We're Strathaven clinging to a 14-12 lead. Both teams making their way back towards the field here. And so we're just a few minutes from getting things restarted, but both teams probably went into the locker room thinking of some missed opportunities for sure. Strathaven had their second drive of the game stall inside the 10-yard line with a false start penalty, turned into a just barely missed field goal that could have been an additional 7 or 3 points on their second drive of the game. Chester hurt themselves with penalties, overcame a couple of them to come take the lead 12-7, but then gave up a couple big plays to Strathaven almost immediately, and 14-12 is where we stand on the strength of two Jake Kitchen quarterback sneaks and two extra points converted by Ben Milligan. Two touchdowns as well for the Clippers, one passing and one rushing for Jalen Harris, but two extra point attempts, the two-point tries have both failed. Strathaven up to the task on the two-point conversion so far.
We have some stats here for you on the screen.
You can see the screen, Mike. You're the only guy who can
I
see
know.
It, so
we
let
don't
it rip.
Monitors up, so.
Let it rip.
All right, Strathaven, it's a very close game, as the score would indicate. 179 total yards, 53 passing, 126 rushing yards, Haven. 10 first downs, one turnover on an interception, which surely was throw it long, hope they catch it. Otherwise, it's a punt. With 13:47 in time possession. Chester, 211 total yards, so they're beating Haven by about 31. Passing yards, 136, much more substantial than Haven, but no shocker there. And rushing yards is 75. They have 8 first downs as opposed to Haven's 10. No turnovers, and that's maybe a key situation here as we go into the second half. And 10:43 in time possession, which makes some sense considering their first touchdown took place in 14 seconds. So.
Right. That 74-yard after Strathaven marched down the field with the opening drive of the game, chewed up half the first quarter with a 66-yard scoring drive, and Chester answered in one play. A 74-yard strike on a quick, well, call it skinny post, I guess, a slant from Jalen Harris to his twin brother, Duran. 74 yards later, Chester was within 1 point. So it's been back and forth all first half long. Second half, Strathaven, we've said early on in the broadcast, they have struggled coming out of halftime on the offensive side of the ball. They've had some tough third quarters, held scoreless last week in the second half by Springfield. I think only scored once against Upper Dublin in the second half. So again, it's been a struggle for the Silver and Black offensively. Defensively, they've done the job. On the other hand, Chester, they've been a second-half team. They have put points on the board and really took care of business last week against Ruston with a big second half, scoring on both the offensive side and defensive side of the ball with Duran Harris's 70-yard interception return for a score, turning out to be the difference in their win over the Golden Knights last Saturday afternoon. So we were talking at halftime, an underlooked play or an overlooked play maybe that is worth mentioning one more time. That interception late in the half with under a minute to go, Duran Harris makes a leaping catch at about the 15-yard line. The tackle, the immediate tackle there by James Fisher could turn out to be monstrous. As if you were here last weekend, you watched Duran Harris pick one off and seemingly touch every blade of grass on the field, weaving his way to a 70-yard interception return. That is not a guy that the Panthers want with the football in his hands in the open field. So good tackle by James Fisher on the interception. May turn out to be a bigger play later on. But in the meantime, thank you to all of our viewers right now. We have thousands watching the
thousands
game right now, both locally and from faraway places, whether you're a family member of a player, just a local fan. Fellow Central League members as well are watching, and Del Valle League members as well. We're thrilled that you're joining us live or on the archive on what we know is a busy Thanksgiving weekend that is important to so many families. And if you're taking a couple hours to enjoy some football, then we hope that we're doing it justice.
And WWON out of New York is also carrying our games. They had big numbers last week. I'm sure they're big numbers this week. And, of course, NFHS, which is a pay-per-view group out of, they're out of Atlanta, but it doesn't make a difference where they're out of. And, of course, we've been building it up. And next week, depending on which team goes to the finals,
the
semifinals for the PIA, right? If it's Haven, we certainly expect to be the broadcast team working for NHFS and broadcasting that game. But we'd be happy to do it for Chester as well if they end up going. We'll just have to see what NFHS is planning for their broadcast crew. So we're looking forward to it. But thank you for all listening and attending and sharing the season with us, which is it's always more fun with friends.
I've mentioned it already in the pregame and briefly a few minutes ago. There are going to be a number of football players today whose high school football careers end. Several seniors on both teams, and that's always a heartbreaking thing, no matter who it is, to play your last high school football game. I want to also mention the band.
Oh, yeah.
This, you know, if this doesn't go Strathaven's way, there are several seniors in that band today who would be playing their final, given their final performance. And Nick Pignataro and that band is just such a special thing for all of us who watch them every week. They get better every week as well. We talk about it from a football standpoint. Coach Clancy, the only goal for him over and over every year is we just want to get better every week. They don't talk about championships and Central League and districts and everything else. They talk about we want to be better next week than we were today. And you can say that for the band as well. So if you're an audience member, whether it's live or on the archive on the broadcast, who just wants to see the band perform, just know that we've enjoyed every minute of that as well, and they've been fantastic. All right, we've had 24 fantastic football minutes so far, 24 to go at the very least, as quarter number three, ready to get underway with Strathaven kicking it away to Chester to begin this second half. Ian Gallagher has it teed inside the far hash, and Deron Harris back on the field in seemingly good shape. He left midway through that second quarter for a series or so, but is back on the field, had the interception in the final minute of the second half, of the first half rather, and he and Quamir Cosby await back near the 10-yard line. Ian Gallagher ready to get the third quarter underway. Packed house here in Chester. Tight game for the District 1 5A final, and third quarter, here we go. Comes down to Cosby, who's looking for room up the near sideline now. Gets a block and lots of room. Flag, no flags here. One man to beat. Gallagher won't get him. Cosby will go 30, 20, 91 yards later. Chester takes the lead. Just nothing doing over here for the Panther coverage unit. Cosby goes from one side of the field to the other. They had it set up, well blocked. Not sure if there was a block in the back or not. You'd have to check the replay at about the 35, 40-yard line. That seemed to be the only moment where Strathaven had some bodies in the way. But great job by Cosby to go the distance. His first kick return touchdown of the season. And 91 yards later, Chester with another big play to take their second lead of the game. 18-14, extra point pending here. It'll be a two-point try. A.J. Glavicek hustles onto the field. T formation behind Jalen Harris. He's going to pass it, look to pass it this time. Looking for Toy. He goes high and hauls it in. The two-point try is good. And Chester by six with 11:45 to go here in the third quarter. The Panther offense will get a chance to answer when we come back on havenfootball.net.
Welcome to Allstate, where everyone saves when they bundle their home and auto insurance. Isn't that right, Frank?
I saved 25%. Booyah.
You protected your casa?
Sure did.
And the Frank tank?
You know it.
And now you're relaxing.
I'm working from home.
Sure you are. Save up to 25% when you bundle home and auto with Allstate.
Your local Allstate agent is Steve Taub in media. Give him a call at 610-566-3500.
This is Keith Jackson. You're listening to High School Football right here on havenfootball.com.
Immediate fireworks to start this third quarter. Quamir Cosby goes 91 yards with the third quarter kickoff. And Chester grabs the lead immediately, 20-14, Mike.
Yeah, you know, that's two huge plays Chester's been able to pick up. First was the first play from scrimmage, the first half, and now this on the kickoff return, opening kickoff return on the second half. This may be the last team scores wins.
Could be. We've got a long way to go. We're just 15 seconds into this third quarter. Short kickoff. It'll angle towards the sideline. Panthers need to pounce on it and do. Heads up play right there by A.J. Glavicek to give the Panthers possession at about the 37-yard line and get the offense back on the field with 11:45 to go here in the third quarter. So you knew coming in that Chester would have some explosive opportunities, explosive players, speed everywhere. But you would have thought that Strathaven might have had a special teams advantage, certainly in the kicking game. But the return game, Cosby burns them big to start this third quarter. Jake Kitchen sends Kaufman in motion on first down and 10. Going nowhere is Shane Green. That's Dominic Toy in the backfield immediately. Green will lose a couple, and it's second down and 12. Well, we said it, you know, coming out of halftime. The Panthers have had a really slow start to the third quarter, yep, several weeks in a row on offense, and now you're behind the sticks here, second down and 12 to go. Clock continues to tick. Sean Henry split to the bottom of your screen to the near side. Tight end to the far side is Jahi Curtis in for Cole Miller. Kitchen back on the rollout, looking for room off that left side, and he's going to float it out to the flat, complete to Shane Green, who makes a man miss. Nope. Good open field tackle by Deron Harris. Saved a first down for sure, and probably more. Gain of about 6 or 7, and it'll be third and 4.
Third down and 4.
10:40 to go here in quarter number 3. Kitchen, 3 out of 6 throwing it now. Green's first catch of the day. Sets up third down and 4. Two tight ends, Henry to the right, Curtis to the left. Off the left side, Kaufman is going to bump his way near first down yardage. He was hit at the line of scrimmage, but got the leg drive going, and I think Kaufman may have moved the chains here.
Yep.
They will move the chains, and a Chester player or two actually slow to get up. So, had a few kids banged up right now. Cole Miller not in the game for the Panthers on offense, and now you've got two Clippers down.
I think it tells you the intensity of this game. These kids are tough kids. They've played all year, but bodies are flying.
All right. Two Chester players down. We're going to take a short timeout with 10:21 to go in the third quarter. Chester leading 20-14. Strathaven on the move when we come back on havenfootball.net.
Your car is probably your second biggest investment, and AMF Auto Clinic in Brookhaven wants to keep that investment in tip-top shape. AMF Auto Clinic has been maintaining automobiles since 1961, and they take pride in their work and in keeping your car in perfect running order. From inspections to general maintenance and repair, you can trust your auto investment to AMF Auto Clinic in Brookhaven. Call for an appointment today at 610-872-2167.
Hi, everyone. This is Greg Murphy from the Phillies broadcast team, where high school football never sounded so good, right here at havenfootball.net.
All right, two Chester players hobble off. Imaj Barrett, your strong safety, and lineman number 50, Wykee Riggins. First and 10 for the Panthers, looking at a couple new jerseys in front of them. Quick hitter to Shane Green, not much doing. Trap play goes for maybe a yard or two, but they were ready to go.
Fans, please clear the track.
All right, second down and call it 9 as Green goes for just a yard. 26 yards on 9 carries for Shane Green thus far. Slow going for the fullback as guard trap and ISO have not been kind to the Panthers just yet. Motion man James Fisher, and you're going to get flags.
Illegal motion.
And you're going to get motion or offside?
Offside is the call.
Offside.
Yep. Oh, it is.
Right.
Wow.
So motion man James Fisher, and looks like Chester defense reacted to him, jumped forward maybe, and turns it into second down and maybe 3. All right. Clock continues to tick. Strathaven trailing for the second time today, but this their biggest deficit yet. 20-14 is where we stand. Sean Henry tight end to the near side. Jahi Curtis to the far side. Second and 3, Shane Green running room this time, and he'll lean for 4 or 5 and pick up another Panther first down. Chester on the stop, Quamir Cosby, who turned this game on its ear to start the third quarter. That 91-yard kick return score. Stephen Dale Jr. checks out of the game from his linebacker spot. And the Panthers with some momentum here at the Chester 42-yard line, first and 10. Wing to the near side, Kaufman, they give and follow that way to James Fisher.
Boy.
Not much doing. Chester just getting to the spot. They go with a pulling guard, Gavin Pilsen, and Pilsen, you know, just wasn't able to get too far ahead of Fisher that time. And not much real estate.
The line slid down effectively, held the blocks. They didn't throw the blocks off necessarily, but they just basically plugged up that opening and no place to go.
Chester defense, again, allows only 11 points per game coming in. Haven trying to add to their 14 at the moment. Second down and 9 from the 40. Kitchen to Green, looking for room, gets a couple. Jarrell Palmer there to meet him after a pickup of 3 or 4. And they'll unpile at about the 38-yard line, 3rd and 6. 4-down territory here for the Panthers for sure, unless you go backwards here.
You really think so?
If you get positive yardage here, I think.
Yeah, because I would think you'd want to bury them as best you can. There's plenty of time to get a score back. Of course, you are relying on your defense. You can't afford any more scores.
They already have a couple explosive plays on offense. So,
all right, Carter Law over the football. Can the Panther offensive line find a way here? 3rd and 6 from the 38. Kitchen, hard count. Chester flinches, doesn't jump. On the delay, they give, and now flag comes late, and let's see here. Flag comes late. They went to Fisher off the left side, but looks like you're going to get dead ball, false start here, a procedure penalty, and now you're going backwards, 3rd and 11. You're going to need something bigger to give yourself a chance on 4th down, maybe. All right, so Panthers back to the 43-yard line of Chester with 7:05 to go here in the third quarter.
And unfortunately, that play that they just ran, it's hard to tell because you don't know who heard whistles,
yeah.
But it was shaping up pretty nicely.
A little more of a cushion here. Only 8 in the box here for Chester. Back to pass, Kitchen on 3rd and 8, looking to the flat. He has James Fisher out there for a catch. They get about half of it back. It'll turn down to 4th and about 5. So gain of 6 for Fisher, and again, not surprising. They want to go rather than a deep shot down the field there, get half of it back, and now you're looking at 4th and 5. Chester defense trying to get off the field. Strathaven at the 36-yard line, clock approaching the halfway mark of the third quarter. Tight end to the left, Jahi Curtis. Henry to the right, 9 in the box for Chester. They go counter crisscross, looking for running room. Fisher turns upfield, first down yardage across the 30-yard line. He needed 5, he picks up 8 to the 29. And James Fisher found some room off that near side. Very well blocked, Mike.
It was very well blocked. You know how it was well blocked? Because the Chester coaches talked about this in the newspaper, among other places, mentioning the crisscross is an effective play they were ready for, or trying to get ready for. So, you know, you know it was great blocking because they knew it. They had a chance they would run it.
1st and 10 from the Chester 29-yard line. Kitchen under center again. Turn, give to Kaufman on the sweep to the far side. Has room over there, cuts it back. Near first down yardage and more. Marco Kaufman bangs his way down near the 16-yard line. Gain of 13 and a Panther first down. So, offensive line starting to get their sea legs a little bit, even minus their 2 starting tight ends right now.
Yep.
Alexi Gustafson out of the lineup today. Cole Miller, injured in that second quarter, is not on the field for this drive right now.
Jahi Curtis. The 17-yard line.
Put it down at the 17. 1st and 10, it's Shane Green. Looking for room, nothing there. Great job crashing through as the leading tackler on the season, inside linebacker Jarrell Palmer. And Green with just a yard there. Brings up 2nd down and 9. Big 4th down conversion on that counter crisscross for the Panthers, and now trying to cash in, trailing by 6. with 4:45 to go here in the third quarter. Tight end to the near side, Henry. Curtis to the far side. They run to that far side. Looking for room, Kaufman. He'll spin his way for the line of scrimmage and not much else. And then a flag comes in very late. We'll see what this looks like. This is...
could be a late hit.
Or holding, maybe.
Oh, it's back in the middle field.
I don't know. We'll see. Came from the back judge late.
Yeah, yep.
Let's see. You're going to get a crackback block. Could be a crackback block there or helmet to helmet. Either way, that's going to move Strathaven way back. So decision time for Coach Shaw. Do you want him at third and eight, or do you back him up to second down and forever? Looks like they'll take the penalty here.
Oh, I would.
Crackback block against the Panthers. That's a penalty that was called against Springfield last week. And
what do we have for down?
Set them back. Now you're back to the 31-yard line.
23-24.
Back to the 31-yard line. Panthers with, I think this is their most penalized game of the year so far. Up to 7 penalties, I think. Here we go. Second and 23. Kitchen back to pass. Off the play fake. Looking. Has time. Has a man out there. Behind the defense is Fisher. It is incomplete and a flag comes in.
Yep.
Two officials threw the flags. Looks like pass interference.
Yeah, it was.
Same thing we had in the first quarter on Chester's touchdown drive.
Yeah.
You also have an injured Clipper down at the 35.
Yeah. All right. So this is, looks like the defensive lineman again.
Looks like number
Riggins.
50,
Riggins had trouble a few moments ago, and he's down for a second time. And Fisher coming back to the football.
Now, how's this work in high school football? I know it's not spot of the foul.
15 yards.
15 and 15. A first down.
Is it an automatic first down? I don't know that it is.
Well, we'll see.
We'll find out.
All right. Wykie Riggins will hobble off for the second time this quarter, so hopefully he's able to return, but... a lot of kids are going to gut it out today. This is a lot of guys who just, they come in banged up, and you've seen several kids go off and back into the game. Deron Harris, Cole Miller, others. So Wykie Harris now will take a seat on the sideline, and subbing in for him, number 61, Zane Tillery.
Pass interference.
And they'll repeat second down.
It is so second down.
15-yard penalty. Still going to be second in about 11 or 12.
It looks like maybe. 10.
Second and 10, okay. Yep. So the crackback block on the previous play, canceled out now by pass interference. Second and 10 is where we land after all of that. From the 16-yard line, Jake Kitchen under center, Fisher, and you're going to get flags again pre-snap. Likely offside or false start yet again. Let's see. It looks like it's against Chester.
Nope.
Jake Kitchen thought it was against Chester. He was pointing the other way.
Well, this is the 15th second down.
All right. The referee signaled offense. Everybody else said against the defense. All right. So now you've got offsides, not. All right. So confusion for the officials there.
Yeah. When you have a game like this with highly emotional crowds, this is not the kind of mistake you want to make when you're officiating.
Second down and 5. From the 11, the Panthers on the sweep to the far side, looking for room is Kaufman, and shooting in
beautifully
is Palmer once again. And now you're looking at third and about 9. Kaufman goes backwards for a few. And Jarrell Palmer with, again, team-leading 19 tackles for loss coming in. He's got a couple more today and puts the Panthers back outside the 15-yard line. Third down and about 10. Henry to the far side with 3:40 to go here in the third quarter. Strathaven trailing by 6, need a big play here. They go Shane Green, quick hit on the trap, and he dives inside the 10 near first down yardage. I think you're looking at 4th and a yard or 2. But they get 8 of it back right there on the trap play.
Yep, 4th and 1 it looks like.
Decision time for Coach Clancy here. Trailing by 6, they'll forego the short field goal. Panthers want to tie it or take the lead here. They need to pick up 2 right now. Kitchen under center, 4th and 2 with 3 minutes to go here in the third. Chester trying to get off the field. It's Green off the left side. Pushes his way for, I don't know, it's awfully close. Awfully close. If they give him the five-yard line, I think it's a first down.
Fourth down marker, looks like he made it.
If he's shy of the five, then they may measure it. And first down it is. He got it. Shane Green needed two and got maybe two and an inch from where we can see. Wow. First and goal to go for the Panthers at their own six. Under center kitchen. Kaufman off the left side. They'll follow Billy Brown for a couple. Not much. Just inside the five to the four. Second down and goal. Panthers would love points right here and would love to continue milking the clock, of course.
And, of course, we're down to less than getting to 2 minutes and 10 seconds in the third quarter.
Long way to go in this one. Panthers were down here earlier. Second down and goal from the five. Jahi Curtis off the lines up tight end to the left. Henry to the right. They shift. And on the sweep to this near side, it's Kitchen looking, has a man out there. It's Henry for the touchdown. Beautiful play fake by Kitchen. And Sean Henry wide open, 8 yards deep in the end zone. And the Panthers have tied it with a chance to take the lead right here.
What a game.
Beautiful, beautiful play call right there. And Clippers just outnumbered. That was just a great design of the play. Fisher and Henry out in the route together. Kitchen all kinds of time to throw it. And now the all-important extra point. Ball spotted, kick is away. Plenty of leg for Milligan. He's good. And the Panthers lead it 21-20 with 1:48 to go here in the third quarter. Stigwiz, you're listening live to high school football right here on havenfootball.net.
Looking for pre-K child care with an emphasis on learning? Ducklings Early Learning Center is available for children 6 weeks to 5 years old within one block of Nether Providence Elementary School on Moore Road in Wallingford. At Ducklings, our college-educated teachers create a safe, nurturing educational environment in our beautiful facility. Call Ducklings today for an appointment at 610-936-9400.
This is Merrill Reese, voice of the Philadelphia Eagles, where high school football never sounded so good, right here at havenfootball.net.
We're back.
Welcome back to the District 1 5A final. 1:48 to go in the third quarter. And what a game we've had. Jake Kitchen's first touchdown pass of the day after two runs finds Sean Henry 5 yards deep in the end zone. And the Panthers have a one-point lead again, 21-20. And now, where do you kick it? Gallagher goes high and short. They'll try it to one of the up men. This is McDaniel. He's dangerous going the other way. Steps away from one man momentarily, but nice job by Shane Green to trip him up at the 35-yard line. Mike, time for the defense to do a job here.
Oh, boy, it's going to be critical. I mean, Haven can bend a little bit, no doubt about it. You know, the problem is, you know, if Chester scores quickly, of course, Haven's got plenty of time. Haven took an awful lot of time off that clock. We're down to 1:43 now on the third quarter. So, you know, it's gonna be interesting to see how this all plays out. It all was before we started interesting before it got going.
Panther defense hustling onto the field here as Chester starts their first drive of the second half at the 35-yard line. Jalen Harris. Snaps on the helmet, takes the shotgun snap. Looks, fires to the flat, complete to Toy. Makes the catch, steps out of bounds. First down, Chester at the 47-yard line. All right. James Fisher in coverage. Shoves him out of bounds after a gain of 12.
Now we're going to see if that's, you know, Chester did not throw much in the first half. Didn't need to. Now, you know, they may feel that that's a weakness.
Dom Toy's second catch of the game. Also had a two-point conversion catch after the kick return. All right, here we go, and Melvin going nowhere. They went out of the pistol, and Nick Farabaugh says hello at the line of scrimmage. No gain for Nareem Melvin on his second carry of the day. Second and 10 upcoming. Now remember, Chester, by scoring so quickly in that first with the opening kickoff of this third quarter, this is the first time the offense has been on the field. So some of these guys go both ways, but your quarterback, Jalen Harris, maybe needs to get a little warmed up here. Back to pass on second down and 10. All sorts of time. Fires underneath. Has a grab for Fitzgerald. Dropped immediately by Sean Henry on the midfield stripe. It'll bring up third down and about six. So good catch. Good throw. Good tackle. Good everything.
Good process there.
Good football across the board there. Third down and call it six as Fitzgerald has his second catch of the day.
Probably four down territory here if they get positive yardage.
See if the Panthers can get a pass rush with 25 seconds and counting to go here in the third. Jalen Harris back to pass and rolling. Looks a little throwback screen to the near side. Looking for room is Dom Toy. Running room. Sheds a tackle. Pulling away from one man, two men. Is hit from behind by Farabaugh. And there's first down yardage for Chester as Milligan and Farabaugh make the stop at the 29-yard line. Gain of 22, and the Clippers go hurry up here. Jeremiah checks out. Bill Brown checks in. And they snap and ready to go. First and 10. They want to catch the Panthers napping, and down the field they go. Has a man incomplete. In and out of the hands of Imaj Barrett. He'd like to have that one back, as Harris was on the money with that one.
That was the end of the third.
Is that it? Yeah, yep. That should have been. Is that the final play of the third quarter?
Yes,
all right.
Yeah.
Took their shot, caught the Panthers in a substitution there, and boy, Strathaven dodges a bullet on the final play of quarter number three. We'll take a short timeout. Be back in 30 seconds. Fourth quarter action upcoming. You're listening live to the District 1 final on havenfootball.net.
Looking to start an exciting career in the healthcare field? Then Keystone Quality Transport is looking for you. Keystone Quality Transport, the region's premier non-emergency medical transportation company, offers a full scholarship into a comprehensive emergency medical technician certification program. Would you like to obtain a National Registry Emergency Medical Technician certification and earn $20 per hour to start? Send an email to hr@kqthealth.com. Start your rewarding healthcare career today.
This is Keith Jackson reminding you you're listening to High School Football right here on havenfootball.net.
Welcome back. Fourth quarter action ready to start here with the top-seeded Chester Clippers trailing number two Strathaven 21-20. Here as we start the fourth. Brian Carroll bringing you play-by-play, joined by Mike Mayer and Andrew Kaufman as always. Mike Clancy doing the job with the camera, so thanks to all of you for tuning in to what's been a terrific three quarters of high school football action on your busy Thanksgiving weekend. Strathaven on the ropes here defensively, a little thinned out with some injuries, and now Chester looking to regain the lead. They have second and 10 from the Panther 28-yard line. Tight formation with a wing
some confusion
to either side. On second and 10, Jalen Harris out of the pistol. They hand it off, looking for running room, trying to turn the corner on the near side. Flag on the play. This could very well be holding. A.J. Glavicek drops McDaniel at the 24-yard line. But this, as a spot foul, is going to turn this into second down and about 22, I believe. So the costly, costly penalty there.
Hales was trying to get off his blocker, but...
Yeah, Vince Hales, you're right, Andrew, made that play. Standing up his blocker, trying to reach outside there to slow down McDaniel, and instead...
Second and...
Yeah.
19 somehow?
That made sense because it was nine-yard line.
All right, here we go. From the 38, Chester ready to go on second down and long. Jalen Harris with McDaniel to his right. Looking left, has all sorts of time, steps up in the pocket, away from Hales, still dancing to his right side, eyes still downfield, now going to keep it himself, and is shoved out of bounds. Big play right there by Nick Farabaugh to knock him out, shy of the 40. Back at the 36-yard line, they'll lose a couple on the play, so Nick Farabaugh with a sack. And you'll turn it down to third down.
Third and 26.
Yep, third and 26.
From the 44.
Zaheem Sabree checks into the game for Chester.
Barrett was looking for a flag. Whoever had him, in coverage did have a nice grab on his jersey a couple of times.
Okay. Yeah, I missed that. But
you can't watch everything.
I mean, look, the way the flags have flown against both
teams
today,
that didn't
nothing,
go.
Yeah, nothing would surprise me at this point as far as the way the penalties have been busy all day long. Two receivers to the left, two to the right. Harris back on third and 26. Look, fires underneath. He's got Sabree in and out of his hands. Fourth and 25 upcoming, and a couple of costly incompletions here for Chester that they'd like to have back.
Boy, that was a tough one to drop.
Are they?
There was room to run, and now fourth and 25. Do you pin Strathaven deep here?
They're going to try to.
Yep. So on the punt, Deron Harris, fourth and 25 upcoming. James Fisher and Ben Milligan await the punt at about the 15, near the first down yardage marker, actually. So even a fake, you've got your two safeties back there. Harris, low line drive kick, and it'll take a Chester hop inside the 20. And boy, this has been the theme of the year in terms of their punting. Harris, it is not something you'd love to see in a punting clinic, but extremely effective. He averages 35 yards a punt, and many of them barely 5 to 6 feet off the ground. That one even lower, but effective
indeed. 31 on that one.
31 on the punt, no return, and pins Strathaven all the way back at their 14-yard line with 11:19 to go here in regulation. Now the Panthers looking to put together a drive. They chewed up most of the third quarter with a scoring drive a few minutes ago. They'll start here, first down and 10. Shane Green bangs his way across the 20 to the 21, following Jackson Jeremiah through the hole. Brings up second down and about four, maybe three.
Three.
Looks like ball's at the 16, or
21 now.
21.
This drive
second and three.
This drive could very easily be the game.
Yeah, if you put it all together, if you put it in the end zone. All right. Panthers with a wing to the far side. They go flag on the play again. Let's see. All right. You're going to get false start again, perhaps? Or is it offside again? Again, it's pre-snap. And offsides again.
Wow.
Against
it's a first
Chester.
Down.
Yeah, that will be a first down. Second and four turns into first and 10 here.
You know, Chester's had an issue with penalties all year long, and I would have thought, you know, and maybe the coach did say, we can't do this, guys. It's got to stop.
We've now got a total of 18 penalties, accepted penalties in the game.
Wow.
Were there any unaccepted penalties?
18.
No.
Well, how many against each team?
12 for Chester, just 6 for Strathaven.
All of them costly, it seems.
Yes,
all
it
of them
seems
in
like
big
it.
Moments for both teams. Tight end to the right is Jahi Curtis. They run that way. On the power run there by James Fisher.
Boy,
he drives
boy.
The pile for 11
boy,
and a first
boy.
Down. Fisher for 11 more. And he's approaching the 100-yard mark, and the Panther offensive line starting to find their sea legs, perhaps.
I got to apologize to our viewers. I am so involved in this game, I keep forgetting to hit the replay, the capture replay button.
Okay.
I'll try to keep remembering. That was worthy of a replay, and I just didn't press the button.
James Fisher, over 1,200 yards rushing coming into the game, averages nearly 40 yards per reception. He's well over 100 in all-purpose yards again today. He is in the backfield, leads Shane Green through the hole on first down for a gain of maybe 3. Out to the 39-yard line. Number 10, Steve Dale on the stop. Brings up second down and about 7. And Mike, you said it. If the Panthers can put one in the end zone here a few yards at a time, that would be... That's a dream scenario for Coach Clancy. Tight end to the near side, Jahi Curtis. Wing to this near side is James Fisher. They give it to Fisher, looking for room off the far side, cuts it back. Slow developing play and nothing doing.
Yep.
Fisher does well to get the line of scrimmage, and that's about it. Maybe even lost a yard.
Yeah.
But third and long upcoming. Panther defense hoping.
Third and 8.
to get a rest here. But now third down and 8. Chester defense and checking out of the game. Wyke Riggins, but good to see him back in the game. He's left twice with a leg injury. He was back in on that last play. Third down and 8 for the Panthers. They go crisscross to the other side. Lots of room for Kaufman. First down and more. Lowers the shoulder. Takes Melvin for a ride across the midfield stripe to the 49-yard line. 13 yards later, James Fisher hands to Marco Kaufman and the Panthers with another first down.
And that was a huge hole. I mean, that just, I don't know what they had done or what Chester was looking at, but they seemed to have shifted all to the wrong side of the ball and just left a huge alley.
Well, it seems like more often than not on the counter crisscross, it's James Fisher that's getting the second handoff. This time it was Kaufman.
Nice misdirection for the Panthers. Sets them up first and 10 at the Chester 49. Give us to Kaufman again off the left side. Gets a push there from Billy Brown. Down to the 45. Gain of 4 more for Kaufman. You have to give me his stats here in a moment. My pen is running out. I have 3 of them. They're all feeling this 35-degree weather, I think. But the three-headed monster for the Panthers in the backfield, Green, here. Fisher, and Kaufman have been equally effective. And then you mix 2 touchdown runs from your quarterback, and the Panthers leading 21-20. And now second down and 6. Kitchen one more time to Green. Steps away from one man. Still on his feet. First down yardage. Tiptoeing across the 40. Tumbles to the 36. And 9 yards later, Panthers will move the sticks again.
Hey, Brian, try this on your pens. Just lay a pen
there
on
you
it.
Go.
Or
the hand warmers.
Yeah.
Genius. Mike is, he does everything. I mean it. We talk about it all the week. Like, he does the website. He does the engineering, the color commentary. Now he's fixing our writing utensils here in 35-degree weather. All right, first and 10 for Strathaven. 36-yard line is where they'll spot it. From the near hash, it is James Fisher. Bumps into his own man and squirts forward for a couple to the 34. All right.
But I think you're right, Brian. I think Coach Clancy is sitting back, and he may not be smiling if we look at him, but I think inside he's smiling. We got timeout.
Timeout on the field. Number 53 was slow to get up.
Have to come
and
off.
Because the officials blew the play,
So Isaiah Payne.
He's got to come off.
Isaiah Payne will hobble off momentarily. His father, Al, was the quarterback here years ago. Yeah, this is a lot of second-generation players on both sides and in this game. So second down and 8 upcoming for the Panthers now. Leading by 1, clock melting, 6:35 to go in regulation. They lead by a point, hard count, and Chester jumps again. Heads up play there from Kitchen with that hard count. I think we'll turn this to second down and 1 or 2.
3, I think.
Okay.
We'll see. You tell me. Yeah, maybe you're right, too.
Put it down to the 29-3. 3, yep.
Oh, it is 3.
I mean, we could just do some simple math, but.
Well, that's what
holiday weekend has got me fried here, I guess.
Yeah, I'm going to go home for turkey sandwiches.
Second and 3. From the 29, Panthers on the move, trying to cash in again, and flags again.
More flags.
Pre-snap.
Oh, boy.
Panthers sideline is clapping. Did someone line off offside again? Kitchen thinks so. Yeah. He's pointing the other way.
Yep.
Offside again.
First
the Panthers,
down.
Nobody jumped. They must have lined up offside. For the third time this drive, Chester with a pre-snap offside penalty. 6:20 to go here in regulation, and the Panthers getting some free real estate here.
Well, they're getting free real estate, and they're getting time off the clock, neither of which Chester wants to deal with.
And Coach Shaw has seen enough. Yep. He'll call timeout and talk this over with his team and maybe the officials. Panthers with some momentum. A 1-point lead and 6:20 remaining on the clock when we come back. Stick with us. You're listening live to High School Football on HavenFootball.net.
Have nagging soft tissue injury, chronic joint pain? Give Rose Tree Wellness Center a call and see Dr. Tom O'Brien for a complete diagnosis and treatment. Dr. O'Brien specializes in active release techniques, ART. ART can deal with many issues, including chronic shoulder, knee, and ankle pain. Rose Tree Wellness Center also offers a complete series of massage therapy as well as general chiropractic care. Don't spend another day in pain. Call 610-789-5555 and make an appointment today.
This is Merrill Reese, voice of the Philadelphia Eagles, where high school football never sounded so good, right here at havenfootball.net.
Welcome back to the District 1 5A final. Chester trailing Strathaven 21-20 and needing a defensive stop right here. Andrew Kaufman, did you have a score update from elsewhere?
Yeah, up in Delaware Valley, Imhotep lead that game 24-7 with 2 minutes to go in the third quarter.
Oh, that's turned around, huh?
Imhotep looks to be the possible opponent for the winner of this one. First and 10 here for Strathaven with some momentum. Shane Green grabbed by the shirt tail and dragged down at the 20, maybe 3-yard line. Gain of just a yard or so for Green on that one.
Maybe two.
Maybe two. Yep. Second down and 8 upcoming. Clock continues to melt. We'll be inside of 6 minutes.
The reason we talk about this, for you people who are wondering why we always get it down and distance talking about, because Brian spots it. Now, I've got to put it in the computer. Andrew's got to add the math. So it's always a discussion.
All right. Wing to the near side, James Fisher. On second down and 8, it's Green one more time. Running room off the left side. Carrying tackler Shane Green with some fourth quarter squat rack legs right now. Down to the 11. And the Panthers threatening again here after an 11-yard run from the fullback. Shane Green was at about 2 yards per carry at halftime. And now
Toy is down injured for the Clippers.
Toy down with his helmet off, and Clippers getting banged up. And at this point, we're going to keep it right here. Toy's up on his own feet and walking off under his own power. So we hold our breath for, I mean, any of these kids that go off the field for either team.
Short of bones sticking out of flesh, they're coming back to play.
These guys, I mean, we've seen, again, multiple kids check themselves back into a game here after just a few plays of rest. All right, yard markers on the ground on the far sideline. That means we're first and goal after Shane Green's 12-yard run. Panthers, 4 shots at it from the 10. Imaj Barrett, he left the game with an injury a while back. He just hustled onto the field. Wing T behind Kitchen. It's Green one more time. Nope, they give it to Kaufman. They faked everybody out there, but Kaufman, good lateral pursuit there from Chester to drag him down. Maybe a yard, if that. We'll see where they spot this. But good fake inside to Green. And better pursuit there from
no gain
Chester to stop Kaufman for no yardage. Panthers from this near hash, trying to find a way into the end zone again. All right. Henry to the far side. Tight end. Curtis to the near side. Motion man, James Fisher. Man-to-man look inside. They give to Green. He'll cut it to his left. Push it down to maybe the 5 or 6. Gain of 4 more. It'll be 3rd and goal from the 6.
Oh, boy. Could they make it any more thrilling?
They always do.
Yep.
We'll be under 4 minutes.
Oh, somebody just went down.
And once again, it's number 53, Isaiah Payne. He's had a couple moments to come off the field with injury today as well. So we mentioned a minute ago, Imhotep has taken the lead on Delaware Valley. Imhotep, top-ranked 5A team in the state, and Strathaven played them in the state semifinal 2 seasons ago.
Yep.
Back in 2021. And if they were able to hang on here for the next 4 minutes and change, could be setting up a rematch next Friday night. And again, with the way the state playoffs work, once you get to these particular weeks, they alternate the sites. So it should be District 1's year to host again. 2 years ago, that game was at Ridley on that Friday night. Not saying it'll be there next Friday, whether it's Chester or Strathaven coming out, but very well could be if it's indeed Imhotep holds on. All right, here we go. 3rd and goal from the 6. Chester defense needing a stop in a big way here. Panthers trying to get positive yards. They go to Fisher. Back to Kaufman on the counter. Crisscross one more time. He's near the goal line and just shy of it. 4th and goal from the 1 as Kaufman on the counter. Crisscross picks up 5. And the Panthers are going to look to put this one away maybe. Clock ticks, 3:46 and counting to play here in regulation. Kitchen jogs in the play, nose of the football on the 1 yard line. Kitchen with two quarterback sneaks for touchdowns already today. Do they go to the well one more time? Panthers with a wing tee behind him on fourth and goal from the one. It's Kitchen off the left side, gets the push and into the end zone for the third time. Jake Kitchen with 3:21. There's still no signal. There it is. Kitchen got the push from Shane Green. And the left guard, Gavin Pilsen, leads him in again with 3:18 to play in regulation. And now, decision time. Well, not really decision.
Not
Ben
really.
Milligan's
get
on the
point.
Field. You get your point. Go up by eight.
Yep.
There is one crazy part in the back of our mind that says you go for two, make it a two-score game no matter what. But an extra point here would give Strathaven an eight-point lead. Ball spotted. Kick is away. Plenty long enough and good. Ben Milligan, 4 for 4 on the extra points. And now Chester will get the football back, trailing by eight with 3:18 to play in regulation. Be back in just a moment. You're listening live to high school football on havenfootball.net.
Selling or buying a home is serious business, and for serious business, the key to your success is to work with an experienced agent. Sandy McCulley has over 20 years of real estate experience and is a seller representative specialist as well as a certified residential specialist. Sandy specializes in Delaware County real estate. Sandy conveniently works out of the Media Berkshire Hathaway Home Marketing Center and Media. Let Sandy's experience be your advantage in today's multifaceted real estate market. Give Sandy a call at 610-368-6641.
This is Merrill Reese, voice of the Philadelphia Eagles, and you're listening to high school football right here on havenfootball.net.
Welcome back to the 5A District 1 final. Strathaven 28, Chester 20 with 3:18 left. The story in the second half has been the Strathaven offensive line just finding their way and plowing lanes for Marco Kaufman, James Fisher, and Shane Green. Jake Kitchen has cashed in three times on quarterback sneaks, and now the Panthers trying to hold on to an eight-point lead with 3:18 left. And where do you kick it? Ian Gallagher approaches. Short, high, end-over-end kick will come down to Larry McDaniel. Trying to reverse to this near sideline. Shane Green spins him down at the 29. So, Chester trailing by eight. Has about 70 yards for a chance to tie it, Mike.
Yep, and you know, this is going to be a wicked 3 minutes because Chester's got every ability to throw it. That's been a weakness for Haven to be able to defend the pass. They've done it reasonably effective, but Chester's such a big break team that at any time they could break one open. So here we go. Let's see how tough Haven can play it.
All right, here we go. Jalen Harris sends the sophomore Zaheem Sabri split to the bottom of your screen. They bunch three men to the top of your screen to the far side. Larry McDaniel in the backfield and Harris on first and 10 from the 29 is back. They throw. This could be a double pass. Deron Harris with room in the backfield looking for his twin brother. Vince Hales is chasing. Eyes still downfield. Dumps it incomplete. Threw it away. There was nobody there and you could have ineligible man downfield. And
yep,
there it is. You've got a lineman 12 yards downfield there.
Yep, 77.
They tried the double pass, and the officials caught it. Good sportsmanship
another
right
flag
here.
That'll be the intentional grounding flag.
It could be grounding or ineligible man or both.
Well, I think you may have the two flags coming out here from the defense for the ineligible man downfield. The flag came out very late from the head official. That usually indicates intentional grounding because having a discussion with his fellow referees.
Looked like they were going for a double pass, a throwback to Jalen Harris. But
they called both penalties, so I guess they get a choice.
Yeah,
loss
it
down.
They'll move this back.
You'll take the intentional grounding here.
Sure, because it's loss it down.
It's loss it down and it's spot of the foul.
Lost
at high school level, is it?
Lost in all of that. Can I just, before we forget?
Yes.
Yeah.
There was a moment there. I don't know if the camera caught it or not. Just terrific sportsmanship between Zaheem Sabri and Marco Kaufman. They got tangled up Kaufman's shoulder pad sticking out. Sabreez wrestling to get his shoulder pad tucked back in.
That
you know,
nice.
For all the intensity and all that's at stake here, to see these student athletes just battling all day long and still to see something cool like that, just love to point it out. Bill Brown checks out of the game. Makai Clark checks in at defensive tackle, trying to help get a pass rush here on second down and forever here for
ball
Chester.
Ball is where the 15, it looks like.
They'll put it down
yes.
on the 15.
So we have first and second and 24.
Second and 24, they go draw play. Inside to McDaniel, looking for running room. Cuts inside, makes one man miss, two men miss, and he gets a big chunk of it back before Ben Milligan makes the stop. They'll mark him out at the 32-yard line. Clock stops with 2:57 to play, and now you're looking at third down and about seven. Bill Brown checks out, Makai Clark in.
That was a big chunk.
That was indeed. Third and about seven. And Bill Brown, nope, he's kicking back out of the game. Makai Clark back in. All right, third and seven. Football at the Chester 32-yard line. All right. Double coverage perhaps down at the bottom of your screen. They give it to McDaniel. Stretch play to the left side. And there to meet him are the Panthers at the 35-yard line. Short gain there. Sean Henry waiting for him along with Vince Hales. Clock ticks, 2:43 and counting to play. Now you're looking at fourth and about four for the Clippers.
Well, they have to go for it. They obviously can't punt it. They may never see the ball again.
Chester still with two timeouts, but they need to convert immediately. McDaniel checks out. A little worse for the wear after that last hit. Split to the far side is Damon Fitzgerald. Bottom of your screen, Deron Harris matched up with A.J. Glavicek, the All-State sprinter. Jalen Harris sends motion to the near side, rolling this way. On third down, Hales is in his face. The throw comes back to the play. It looks like it's going to be intercepted. Intercepted indeed. Sean Henry grabs it. Great pressure from Vince Hales, and Sean Henry steals it away. And the Panthers with an eight-point lead, 2 minutes away from a district title perhaps. And now you get a flag that comes in late. Let's see here. You're going to get unsportsmanlike on somebody. Not sure who.
I think he pointed somebody on Strathaven.
Well, let's see. Dead ball, unsportsmanlike
on
against
Chester.
Chester, which will march this football down near the 22-yard line.
Well, it'll be half the distance. Or no.
No, not yet.
No, we're just.
Not yet.
Just outside that range.
Sean Henry's second interception of the year in a dogfight there for the ball with Dom Toy near the first down marker. And what a job by Vince Hales getting pressure in the face of the quarterback, Jalen Harris. 2:03 to go here in regulation. Panthers need at least one first down. I think there's still two timeouts, Mike, available for Chester.
Two for Chester, three for Chester.
Okay. Sean Henry, tight end to the right. Tight end to the left, Jahi Curtis. On first down, it's Kaufman looking for room off the left side, not finding much. Hit there by Jarrell Palmer, along with seven, Kamir Cosby. Cosby a little worse for the wear as well. And then timeout Chester with 1:57 to go here in the fourth. Second down and maybe
nine
to go. Oh, my goodness.
Yes, oh, my goodness is right.
Why don't we take 30 seconds, Mike? Be back in just a moment to see if the Panthers can hang on. Looking for district title number 13. 1:57 to go. We'll be back in a moment on havenfootball.net.
Do you have slow running drains? Are you thinking about selling your home or property? If so, go to scarpignatoplumbing.com and schedule a technician. They are the area's only small plumbing company to offer in-house trenchless sewer and water main repairs. They also offer sewer lateral certifications for the surrounding communities. From faucets to water heaters, they can handle all your plumbing needs. Give them a call at 484-832-5566.
This is Keith Jackson reminding you you're listening to High School Football right here on havenfootball.com.
Now,
welcome back to the 5A District 1 Championship. Strathaven leading 28-20. Second down and nine from the Chester 21-yard line. They need a first down to ice it. Chester trying to get a stop. Hard count, and there's a jump again for Chester. Another encroachment penalty. That has to be four or five of them on the day. Most of them in the second half here, as the Clippers have hurt themselves terribly with penalties, especially here in this second half. Second and nine now turns to second and four. Kitchen jogs in the play. Senior quarterback Jake Kitchen, three touchdowns on quarterback sneaks today and a touchdown pass to Sean Henry. Henry also with an interception to set this up. Second down and four upcoming. Give inside to Shane Green. Up the middle he goes for a couple. Inside Shane the 15 to the 14. Green, the ball carrier. And now you're looking at third and maybe a yard. Timeout, Chester. That is their third and final timeout with 1:45 to go here in regulation. If the Panthers can pick up a first down here, they may not need to run. They may be taking a knee. We'll see. I don't know. We'd have to do some quick math on that. They may need to keep running plays and try to score here. That's probably your safest bet if you're...
Yeah, at least run one, get a first down. Well, of course, then it's over.
All right. So, 1:45 to go here in regulation. Chester out of timeouts. Strathaven with third and a yard, or two maybe. Third and two, call it. From the Clippers 14-yard line. What a game we've had here today. This Panther defense essentially has pitched a shutout in the second half with the exception of the opening kickoff. On third and two, the give is to Kitchen. Quarterback sneak off the right side this time. Second effort, I think, has gotten him there. Maybe,
maybe a yard. Sure, okay. Right.
I think they got a yard. Still going to be short, it seems. All right, we'll see where they spot this.
Let this clock run.
Yeah, 1:20. Referee still, they're still waiting to spot the football. Okay, and this is taking longer
official
than
timeout.
Chester would like. Clock's ticking. There is no timeout here, and the clock ticks. Fourth and inches for the Panthers. Chester can get the football back right here with a stop. Panthers with a conversion will ice it and grab their 13th district title under Kevin Clancy. Double wing, under center, it's Green off the right side, spins his way forward, and he has first down yardage, and the Panthers will be able to take a knee with 39 seconds to go, and the crowd on the far sideline will go home smiling. Strathaven 28, Chester 20. The Panthers will need to snap it one more time. And Coach Kevin Clancy continues with his 13th district title. This one now coming 30 years after his first.
The it first looks like one they may not have to snap it.
Yeah. First one in 1993. And now, 30 years later, put another one in the books. The 2023 Strathaven Panthers are again your District 1 champions for the second time in 3 years. Unbelievable. Unbelievable job by this defense. Defense pitches a shutout in the second half with the exception of the kickoff. And Chester comes up just a hair short on their first ever trip to the District 1 final. But this Chester team will be back for sure.
Oh, next year, I don't really want to think about that potential.
The potential
the
for this Chester
two years.
Team. This team with so many sophomores and juniors on the field today, Chester has a chance to make one heck of a run. So congratulations to Coach Shaw and his staff and the Chester players. What a phenomenal football game today. What a phenomenal season for the Clippers as they finish 12-2, your district as your Del Valle champions. And boy, oh boy, has Chester put on a heck of a show here this afternoon. But it's the silver and black once again plowing through Thanksgiving weekend with a victory. Strathaven 28, Chester 20. We'll come back, catch our breath, and a wrap up and talk a little bit about more football next weekend right here on havenfootball.net.
The Swarthmoreian Weekly Newspaper has partnered up with havenfootball.net. The Swarthmoreian was established in 1893 and is a true community newspaper and covers the Wallingford Swarthmore School District as well as events in Swarthmore, Wallingford, and surrounding communities. Get your copy every Friday at 320 Market or Swarthmore Co-op or call 610-543-0900 for a mailed subscription. For all the local news, read the Swarthmoreian every week.
Hey fans, this is Todd Lights, public address announcer for the Los Angeles Dodgers, and you are listening to High School Football right here at Haven Football.
Our favorite part of any Strathaven game is happening to our left on the far sideline right now. Win or lose, the silver and black goes down and salutes the band and sings along to the alma mater, win or lose here. But boy, don't they feel better when the scoreboard goes their way. As Strathaven, again, what a remarkable run. We mentioned it earlier on, they lost the district final, the first ever 3A district final in the creation of the District 1 tournament back in 1992 to Hatboro-Horsham. And now 13 trips to the district final since then, all victorious. Just incredible. Coach Clancy has been the constant, but Jim Connor has been there since 1996. Dan Schaefer soon after. And then, you know, you've got Brian Feely and on the defensive side as well. This coaching staff, year after year, just continues to amaze with players who, you know, just tons of dedication, tons of talent, and just phenomenal effort this year. Andrew, we were talking every game this year with almost incredibly competitive and entertaining.
Incredibly competitive, entertaining, close, hard fought on both sides. Both teams came out, played one heck of a football game here today.
Chester, nothing to be sad about in terms of the season, albeit, you know, you always want to go home with a championship. On your home field especially, Chester earned this number one seed with some big wins this season. Loved having the home game here. Just didn't go their way today. Too many penalties, and frankly, the Chester defense wore down. Panthers offensively controlled the clock in second half, cashed in when they could, several key fourth down conversions, and just a marvelous job by Strathaven. And Chester just didn't have enough in the tank.
Speaking of that time of possession,
yeah,
in the second half, Strathaven held the ball for 20 minutes.
Wow.
Yep.
Chester
yep.
had it for just for four.
20 minutes of time of possession that
second
half. But
you're holding the ball for for 20 minutes of the second half. 9 times out of 10, I'm going to guess you're going to win the football game.
Yep.
All right, well, stay tuned to the website. You'll get all the stats tonight, maybe?
Probably tonight.
Okay, tonight and tomorrow, of course, I'll produce play of the game. And then we got to start talking about next week. Now, again, havenfootball.net officially, or the high school, will not be broadcasting the game. This will be on NFHS. It is a pay-per-view. It'll cost you $11 for a month. You can watch a ton of sports in that month, and you can cancel at any time. But I will tell you that if we're broadcasting, we get a substantial portion of that $11. So you're kind of contributing to the fundraising for havenfootball.net for the 2024 football season.
All right. That's a reason to do it right there.
That's right.
We've been thrilled to bring this kind of action to you since 2006. We were the first ones in Delaware County to run these broadcasts on a website, and have just had a blast doing it regardless. Win or lose, just a phenomenal commitment from Mike Mayer to make it happen. I was on the radio for years doing Strathaven games before this, but you know, since the technology gives us what it gives us, since 2006, we've been able to do this every week, win or lose. So thank you again to LaDante Bell, the AD here at Chester, for getting us set up. Dave Berman for his assistance in that as well. It's been a wonderful day to watch and talk about football. And all the more wonderful when the home team just gives us a great spot to sit and enjoy it. And the visitors today your Strathaven Panthers, the 2023 District 1 5A champions. I'm going to have to keep saying that out loud to believe it. With the number of games this year that went to the wire, one score games, which seemingly week after week. But yes, this team is tough. They are resilient. They do not scare easily, whether they're down tight games or not. It's been a really brutal Central League this year, a very even Central League this year with co-champs with Springfield and Garnet Valley and Strathaven together. And, of course, other tough teams in there as well. So, boy, they've earned every inch of this. Now you lick your wounds. You hope everybody's healthy to take on what we think will be Imhotep.
It is Imhotep. It'll be Imhotep. Delaware Valley 31-7.
In a rematch of 2 years ago in the state semifinals. We'll see what Strathaven can put together next, we think, Friday night. Stay tuned for more in the days ahead on havenfootball.net. In the meantime, go enjoy the rest of your Thanksgiving weekend. For Mike Clancy.
We will.
Oh, yeah. We will. Mike Clancy on the camera. Phenomenal job. Mike Mayer doing the engineering, color commentary. Andrew Coffin with the stats, spotting, and more. Your final score one more time. The District 1 5A championship goes to Strathaven for the 13th time in 14 tries. And the Panthers go home happy 28-20. This is Brian Carroll signing out. Good afternoon, good evening, everybody, and great football.
This internet broadcast has been a production of HavenFootball.net Incorporated. All rights are reserved. Thanks for watching and good night.